Hey guys, I just wanted to share my skin routine.
Shut your fucking mouth!
No problem, John.
Shut the fuck up, you cunt! Shut it!
I came to laugh at you.
Chopper Reed here. Now it occurred to me there might be kiddies watching, yeah? Hello, kiddies. Fucking hello.
Fucking hello, kiddies. How we doing, boys and girls? We're back after a little bit of an Easter break, but if only the show took a week off for Easter, that would be an Easter miracle, in my opinion. The show should have died on Friday.
No resurrection.
It should have just stayed dead. I'm still hoping. And it's not going to happen. But I have my fingers crossed for, like, you know how they were like, oh, we're going to do like 3 seasons of Cowboy Bebop. And then after the first season, they were like, yeah, nah, we're done. We're done. Everyone hates us and all that. And what is so funny is earlier today when I was on the phone with my dad catching up with him, he said to me, he said, oh, there used to be quite a lot of Halo advertisements around here on like bus stops and stuff like that. And he goes, they're not there anymore. And I'm like, yeah, it's because the show's shit. And he's like, yeah, I figured. You can normally tell by how quickly they take down all the adverts on bus stops and stuff like that, if it's doing well or not. But we are here, boys and girls. We're going to be talking about Halo episode 4, unfortunately.
If I can remember it.
I said earlier on Twitch, I'm like, I can't remember this episode and I'm not rewatching it. So I'm just going to bring it up and click through it and it'll all start coming back into my head.
That was the best thing about this one. It was so boring. It just instantly evaporated from my mind.
Yeah, you forget about it instantly as the episode ends. But we are joined by the Dragon of England, Disparu. How are you doing?
Yeah, hello. I'm good. Yeah, I'm desperately trying to remember anything apart from the fact that I know there was double the amount of cheeks in this episode than there was in the last one. And
yes!
I'm still wondering, like, the question on the tip of my tongue is, does Lady Gravemaster think these cheeks are superior to the cheeks of last week or not? Because she wasn't impressed last week. And
no,
I do really want an answer to that question.
She was not happy with the cheeks last week, that's for sure. Lady Gravemaster is a maybe at this stage. You know, we normally do it on the other day that we do, and that works a bit better for everyone. But with Easter, we're a bit behind all that. So she might pop in. But if she does pop in, we'll be sure to get her opinion about the butt cheeks. Now, someone who is very pro butt cheeks, our boy Mike, how you doing?
Yeah, well, you got to clap the cheeks wherever you can find them, you know. You know, clappable cheeks are a rare commodity these days, but unfortunately, Halo is not one of the commodities. I don't wish to clap any of the cheeks on this show, even on my worst day.
I showed both of you this. Yeah. So this dude here, he makes this tweet, bare ass bingo, and he's got all the characters. And look who liked the tweet. Halo on Paramount Plus liked the tweet.
Yeah. You can't make this shit up sometimes. I just couldn't believe it.
Oh, it's got to be the alien, doesn't it? It's got to be the Covenant Elise. That's what I want.
Yeah.
Well, this is,
I mean, we got close this episode, actually. I wasn't looking at which part was exposed.
All they had to do was roll him over and would have had some Sangheili butt cheeks. But Halo on Paramount Plus, they, you know, they're into bingo. You know, the age-old question, are you a tit person or an ass person? Paramount are ass people.
Definitely. And,
100%.
I think the only thing that can be said is maybe they're subconsciously trying to tell us that this show is ass. And that's why there's all the ass in the show. It's like they're geniuses for doing that. All right, anyway, let's get the chat up and see who's in here. I see from the top, I see Dan Blackroyd. It says Lyndon Muscles.
Oh my God, dude. Did you see him last night?
I didn't. I've seen his Twitter, but I didn't see him.
Yeah, he went off on Twitter, and then Jeremy had him pop in the show last night for a little bit to defend himself, basically. Oh, and he went full fucking Mazza and started yelling at the chat. And being like, don't you don't fucking, you know, you don't get to tell me, you dogs. Like, and Jeremy straight up stopped and was like, listen, chat, that's not how you talk to them. He's like, if you're going to double down and start screaming at the chat, they're going to get mad at you. He goes, it's not what you said. It's that you won't stop yelling at everybody in the that disagrees with you.
Too much muzzle.
He did say you've got like a presentation problem, and he just went, I don't care, they can all hate me. I'm like, that's exactly why.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck to dogs. And you're like, yes, we get it. Yeah.
fucking dog. Yeah. Oh man, too much muzzle. Too much muzzle. If you're gonna go down the muzzle path, you gotta commit. You can't half-ass being a muzzle.
Nope.
Yeah, every topic, not one.
Yeah.
Gaming or what? How you doing? Yeah. Abominations here. Good day, sir. Our boy Trey's here. Hello, Trey. We have Amber. How are you doing, Amber? Good to see you, Amber. Sub motherfucking human is here. Master Cheeks. Yep. Master Cheeks. God damn. We got some late game. Yeah, not according to Lady Greymaster.
Strictly average or below average Cheeks.
Boss Hole. Let's fucking go. A shy barn. Good to see you, Boss Hole. Boss Hole feeling good. We got the beautiful A2D2 here. How are you doing? The lovely Mara. Hola! How you doing, Mara? Good to see you. I think we got some love for Disparu.
Disparu.
What were you trying to say? Disparu.
Disboo-woo. Yeah.
Quality over quantity. He's referring to butt cheeks in this one. Oh, have you guys seen all this that's going on? Angry Joe's had his review taken down 3 times. Manually.
He says it's only on the ones he doesn't like. Like, he liked not this episode, but the one before. He was quite positive about that one. Said it was getting back on track, and they didn't take that one down, even though he had the same clips in.
Well, so. Because I watched part of the one video, and he was saying that they their manual strike on one of his videos, they were like, or the digital strike, like the automatic strike, he cut the section out, and it just moved the strike down the video to a section where it's just them talking, and it's nothing on the screen. And he's like, what the fuck am I supposed to do about this? And then they told him, if they're like, if you remove this much of the video, we'll automatically release the strike, and it's like over like 90% of the video. And he's like, well, yeah.
Well, what's the point?
Yeah.
But he had his
manual as well.
Yeah, yeah. It'll be manual. Yeah. He had his episode 4, which is this one, taken down, and he's re-uploaded it like 2 or 3 times.
Yep.
And they just keep taking it down, man. And it's all manual as well. So it's pretty sus. They don't want you talking bad about this show, but honestly, I don't see how you cannot talk bad about this show. There's some Halo channels I watch where they've just outright turned shill, so I turn them off. And there's like one or two where you can see there, they're like, it's not good, but I don't want to say it's not good.
even Uche, Mr. Halo Shill himself, was like, damn, I get it, but like, can we please stop seeing Master Chief with his helmet off? Can we see him with his armor back on, please? And I was like, it's because the show's ass, bro. But
literally,
this episode, his helmet's on and off like a pogo stick. It's all the time.
They can't resist. Yeah,
it's a troll. That's what it feels like. Where he takes it off. Well, sorry, it's not how he puts it on, and the next day you see him take it off.
Yeah,
it's an arrow fucking troll,
he only
maybe.
Puts it on to protect himself while he's traveling in the car. And then he needs it to see something. That's the
and then,
only 2 reasons.
And then he puts it on. Oh, we'll get to that point. The part where he puts it back on pisses me off too. But yeah.
It's so bad. Metal Long's here. Good to see you, Metal Long. Thank you for coming, sir. Listen to the Halo 2 soundtrack. Oh, so good. Halo 2 soundtrack. Breaking Benjamin. EGP. This show is going downhill way faster than I thought it would, but I do enjoy these streams. Good stuff. Well, thank you. Thank you. I'd like to say that we are the best parts of this Halo show, and we're not even in the fucking show.
Yeah.
We've had out the best parts. So with all that said, 100%. I think we should
got more get facial expressions
into it. Yeah. Oh, there you go. That's my facial expression.
Yeah.
I'm a super soldier.
It's kind of constipated look.
All right, let me bring it up here. Okay, so right off the bat, we're greeted with a little flashback to the Spartan 2 program when they're kids, they're being trained. I did appreciate that they brought in Menendez. That's right. He's the drill sergeant who's constantly yelling at him. So that's, I liked that, but silver timeline, so it means nothing to me. And they do make a little gray team reference as well. But still, whatever. So.
But Silver Team too, so you know that still exists.
Kai. Now, last time I was talking about how I can't remember any of Silver Team's names. I learned Kai's name in this episode because she's very prominent in this episode. And holy shit on fucking titties! Is it? Wow. Yeah, we'll get through it. But Mike, the opening scene, the kids being trained. What did you think of this coming out from young John and all that?
I was like, cool, all right, they're showing the kid soldier thing, I guess. But even with that, you know that the thing that you know that the treatment of these children is way worse than what you're seeing. I can appreciate the concept of, like, we're showing these kids already doing military training, and then we're gonna show Halsey fucking gaslighting this child into being like, oh no, you volunteered for this stuff, you just don't remember, you want to be here. I appreciate all that until you fucking see Halsey's de-aged shit ass CGI face just coming up in a second, and I was like, oh fuck, wait a minute,
it's really weird.
It's really fucking weird. And I'm like, you know, I get everybody's going to say, you know, all the shills are going to say, yeah, but budget and budget, 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 budget. And I'm like, they have a big budget. Paramount has fucking money. And the CGI is better in like the de-aging is better in fucking Patrick Stewart's face in X3, which was like a fucking travesty, than it is in this. Like, I was like, what the fuck? And I know that will seem like nitpicking to like some people, but guess what? They deserve to be nitpicked at this point because they put it in the show. They wasted our time making us look at her. They could have just never shown her face.
Her de-age CGI is just her with longer hair. That's all it is.
Yeah. I was like, what the fuck, dude?
I didn't know it was even CGI. To me, it just looks like someone's applied makeup with a trowel. It's like, I think that's where the budget went. I think it just went on makeup, and it's like 6 foot off her face. It genuinely doesn't look like human anymore.
Yeah. The question we get to ask is here. The lovely Lady Gravemaster is here. She's muted at the moment, so we'll give her a moment. She did say that she won't have too much time if she could make it. So
yeah, I'm sorry I'm late. I just had to take out. I just had to take out an aggressive customer. So.
I mean, wow. Okay. That's
what you take out. Do you mean like you beat the shit out of somebody?
Yeah.
Like
picked him on the floor?
I had to put him on the ground.
Lady Gravemaster with the body slam. Oh my God.
Well, it was actually just small joint manipulation. It wasn't anything too spectacular, I promise.
Well, it still sounds pretty spectacular.
I basically put him in an arm. I caught his punch and then put him in an arm bar, is essentially what happened.
Wait, did someone actually swing at you? Are you being serious or?
Yeah.
She takes it. Fuck? She's so actually, calm about it.
Yeah.
People motherfucker took a swing at me. Motherfucker, he fucked around and found out.
I mean, wow. It's when they. His form, yeah, I'm okay. His form was really bad. He was being really aggressive with one of my coworkers, and. Yeah, he threw out a punch with really poor form, so it was easy to use his momentum against him.
So you bash someone at work is what you're like Moz's hero.
I don't know about that. But yeah, I pinned him and then he calmed down and got him to leave and told him, you know, if he has a concern or something, he can come back when he's in a better frame of mind.
So you gave him, you just humiliated him. You said, come back when you've calmed down. You treated him like a child.
Wow. Essentially, yeah.
You said it really nice. Step. I was like, yeah, get the fuck out of here. You come back. Don't come back unless you want another ass whooping. You got to embarrass him. You really got to remind him what's going on, you know?
He's going to go through like a Rocky montage.
Well, it was kind of, you could tell, this was someone who probably watched a lot of other people throw punches and maybe he learned how to fight from Halo, because I don't know if you guys have watched the fight scenes in this, but they're ridiculous.
Dear God. Well, I was going to say, Lady Gravemaster sounds like she's a better fighter than any of the fucking Spartans.
It was really easy to just kind of slip back into training.
You know what? And this is bad to say. There's more action in your story than this whole episode.
Yeah. It's been far more interesting.
This is way more interesting. I want to do a breakdown of your day.
Yeah. Well, let's Lady Greg must have beat up people.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't. He left. I mean, he was a bit disheveled, and I think his pride took a couple of hits, but. He left uninjured, and so did everybody. Like, nobody else got injured, which is, you know, the whole point. But it was just, you know,
oh yeah,
you go through training for it. You just match force, and he was, I mean, telegraphing is, he may as well have just announced that he was going to punch, because he turned towards me, and then the reason it was so easy was because he didn't set his feet, so he wasn't in a proper stance. And then he rotated and cocked his upper half of his body, and then had his arm go all the way back, and then came forward like he was trying to do a haymaker, but a really bad one.
How do you fucking? She's like.
So let me get this straight. You just had a customer come at you all aggressive, like wanting to attack you, and you've just humiliated him, and you're like, "Oh, I just got to go jump on a stream and talk about some Halo. Get the fuck out of here."
Yeah, I mean, I love Halo.
Your dog.
I would never miss this for anything. That, like, I'm sorry that I'm late. I'm sorry that that asshole took up some of your time.
You got assaulted. You don't have to apologize for being late. You beat the shit out of someone.
You're watching this stream. Motherfucker, you got what you deserve.
Hey, you got bashed by Lady Gravemaster.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I think his pride took a couple of hits. He's there thinking he's going to beat the crap out of you, and you're just like, it was just a bit of small joint manipulation.
I caught his punch, and then all you have to do, really, there's three pressure points in the hand that you can go for, or you can go for the easy thing and just go for the knuckles. Yep. And you just twist the knuckles, and then they get uncomfortable, and then you chicken wing them, and then they're in an armbar. It's really easy. Like, all these people are trying to, like, Jet Li or Bruce Lee the shit out of people. They're like, oh, pressure points this, pressure points that. And, like, no, I'm just going to go for the knuckles, because that's easy. Like,
God damn.
Dude easily had, oh, God, he easily had 60, 70 pounds on me. There was no way, like.
I'd be lying to say I wasn't turned on a little bit by this.
Yeah. Hey, Lady G, how you doing?
The other part of this is if Lyndon was watching, he'd be totally turned on because he likes strong women. So,
you know. Well, I have my husband spars with me, so that helps a lot too.
I'm sure he does. I hope he spars with you. He's your husband.
This is goals right here. I want a wife that can keep up with me in a fight.
It's good stuff. But sorry if I'm talking weird. Like, my heart's still kind of pounding.
You're totally fine. What
the fuck are you apologizing for? You just beat the shit out of a guy. Come on now. We get it.
I got something that will make you laugh. All right, Lady G. Okay. I showed that to Luke. These two guys.
But I don't agree.
Mike's being hyperbolic. You're so sweet.
What are you talking about? You beat the shit out of a guy. No, you didn't.
I didn't.
Hyperbolic at all. You fucked him up. You ruined his day.
Yeah, but you didn't through your own restraint. Once you've got him on the floor, that's it. You could do whatever you wanted to at that point.
He literally fucked around and found out, and I am all about that.
You know what you should do now? You should go up to his wife and just spank her on the ass really fucking hard.
Yeah. She's your wife now.
Yeah, she's your wife.
That's how it works.
Yeah,
Mike doesn't make the rules.
No, I don't make the rules. I just this is how it works, man. You fucked up. Now she belongs to Lady Gravemaster. I don't know what to tell you, man.
So we have Halo. We now have bare ass bingo for Halo.
I love this.
So it's all starting to get ticked off a little bit. Halo on Paramount Plus actually liked the tweet of this guy making bare ass bingo. That's pretty wild, isn't it? So you weren't too impressed with Master Cheeks last week. You thought his butt cheeks were shit, to put it frankly. What did you think of the Chick Spartan's butt cheeks in this episode? Not a fan? Better? Average? We're all dying to know.
I know this is going to sound really superficial, and I'm so sorry.
How can he sound more superficial than his question?
What do you think of her butt cheeks?
Well, she clearly doesn't squat. Like, it just went from, like, back to leg. Like, there was a slight curve, but there was, like, not. It's kind of like the way that, if you guys have ever checked out Brie Larson's ass, because I know that Lethal has never done that, ever, but. She's got a flat booty. Brie has got a flat booty, but when she does certain poses, she can, like, make her booty pop up. When I saw this butt, it was the same thing. She was manipulated, like, the way that she had the way that she was standing and the way she was doing stuff, and they used camera angles and lighting, and who knows, maybe a butt double. I have no idea. But I was like, that is not her ass.
Like, well, you can't talk about the Halo show without talking about butt cheeks.
Yeah, apparently. I'm just not really sure what they're like what their end goal is. Like, it worked for Game of Thrones because it was Game of Thrones. It doesn't work for Halo. Like, well, you wouldn't be. Why are so many Spartans out of their armor? Like, they literally never take this shit off because at any moment they could be in a life or death situation. Like, but, Chief no. even explained for anybody that hasn't played the games or hasn't been, you know, a fan of Halo or read any of the comics or the novels. But in the first episode, Chief explains why he never takes off his gear, why he never takes off his helmet. He keeps it on because this, you know, it's calibrated, everything's up there, and at any moment he could basically be attacked. And then he takes off his fucking helmet. Plus, this armor is like Gen 2 at best, the one that's in the show, which means this is some heavy ass shit.
Yeah.
Like, he's not going to be able to just like throw it back on.
Well, that
he's
that
not
implies
be able to just throw it back on.
That once again, that implies that they put any thought into this. They just picked an armor, said, "Yeah, that looks cool. We'll wear it." You know.
All right, then. What about Vicious butt cheeks? In this episode, we got 4 butt cheeks.
We did.
We're starting to tick them off.
Yeah. Come on now, Lady Gravemaster. Go down. We're going down the list. The next set cheeks. Of butt cheeks. What did you think?
I am unimpressed by all butt cheeks in this show because clearly they have not put in the work. I want to see Cortana's butt cheeks.
I want to see Cortana. And I'll be real, man. I'll tell you what. This Halsey chick, she's kind of doing it for me lately, man. But you know who's going to be the next one on the show, butt cheeks? Creepy, rapey scientist dude.
Yes, absolutely.
100%.
And probably in front of Halsey's clone.
Halsey clone.
Yep. Yep.
Spit on me, clone mummy. all right. Let me go. That was a super chat, first of all. So we have Miss Martin Muse with a 99-cent super sticker. It is a rose. Mwah. Thank you very much. Mwah. Lovely lady. Blabs wants you to teach her how to kick people's ass.
Blabs is into it.
Yeah, Blabs is into it. Blabs loves violence. Last Toxic Male with a 10 for a super chat. Thank you very much, Last Toxic Male. Thanks to Lord Eric, Dispa fucking Rue, M-I-K-E, Mike, and Lady Gravemaster for enduring 4 episodes of Master Cheeks and his bicycle helmet.
That's what I started calling it, because he only wears his helmet when he's driving for protective headgear. I'm like, you've reduced it to a bicycle helmet at this point.
That is accurate.
Fucking embarrassing, man.
Oh, my
God. I just don't understand. Why is it, like, why is it so hard for them to make a good show? Because they used to be, I remember being younger, and anytime I would see like TriStar Paramount, I knew I was in for a treat. You know what I mean? And like, then TriStar went away, and it was just like, so it, like TriStar and Paramount, or was it TriStar and Columbia, whichever, like they combined. And so then it was just Paramount. And then it was just Columbia. But anytime I saw that studio name pop up, I was like, okay, we're clearly in for like a really good story, or we're in for like a really good show. It's going to, for the very least, it'll be entertaining. And now when I see Paramount, I'm like, odds are this is going to be absolute shit.
It's because you stop hiring based off talent. You start hiring based off, oh, well, we need this and this, and we balance out that kind of stuff. And so that goes all the way up the company. And I also think when it comes to especially when it's like action things like this, can you imagine making a TV show about a guy when you think that men are essentially terrible things, and men being aggressive and in the military is also bad, and women should rule everything? So they have to humiliate Master Chief. That's like the basis of the show, but that ruins the show. So they're trying to come up with some kind of balance between it all, which is probably how you end up with the fact that all the women in this seem to just be complete lunatics, but they think that's really strong women, and that's all women should act that way. Like, I dread to think if they ever actually manage to take power. It's like, if the world turns into this, I'm off. The meteorite can hit us.
Well, and you know, that's a great, like, the thing is, the way that they're writing these stories, it's literally all women's fault.
Yeah,
but they think that's them in power. Like, they think these women are making great decisions.
Yeah. And it's they're terrible decisions. And also, the state of the current world, or the current have they given because like you obviously have the USNC, but like have they gotten into any of the like alliances or the federate? Like I've not seen it. Like they've not actually put a name to anything. Like there's no interplanetary alliance or anything like that. It's just all the USNC is trying to
insurrectionists, just yeah. a general term.
And you're like, okay, but to be an insurrectionist, you have to be if you're gonna be an insurrectionist, there has to be an established government or alliance that you're insurrecting. Like you cannot be an insurrectionist if there is not a formulated, established entity of power. It's impossible. Like you have to have that established. That has to be that has to be stated or that has to be shown somewhere. It's not just the USNC. The USNC doesn't run Earth. They don't run, like, they are the military force behind it. So we're missing half of what Halo needs in order to make sense as to why the USNC is out there pushing these bounds and trying to bring in these different planets. And now the Covenant has shown up. And so now the USNC's mission has changed, at least not in this show. Like they're still fighting the insurrectionists and the Covenant. Like
there
it doesn't
no
make
covenant
any sense.
In this episode. We're in the fourth episode of a Halo show and there's no Covenant.
We're fucking Covenant, yeah.
Yeah.
How long
and
did
so,
it take
like,
them to get to Madrigal? Because they were like leaving for it in the last episode. Like, yeah. Oh, they'll definitely arrive in this one. No.
Nope.
She got lost on the way.
This show seems the best way that I can kind of try and explain this show. Have you guys okay. Don't judge me. I grew up in the north and it gets
you're
very
gonna be judged.
Boring. Just gonna be judged.
You can't enter the stream going, oh, I just fucking bashed some Gronk. But don't judge me.
Come on, hey, man. I didn't hit him. I just used his momentum against him, and then the floor is what hit him. Okay. Yeah.
Yep, oh, that's like that Tom Cruise film where he says, you just killed that bloke. I didn't kill him. I shot him. The bullets and the fall killed him.
There we go.
There you go. No, but like, okay, have you ever poured boiling water into a frozen pond, like a frozen dish of water or anything like that, like over ice or anything? Okay. It's actually a lot of fun, but also it causes like an insane reaction, but it takes, like, you don't see it happen. It looks like it's instantaneous, but someone actually slow-mo'd it on like an old camcorder camera, not because this was before we had GoPros and stuff. But essentially what happens is it looks like nothing's happening. And then the bowl, because you have to use a glass bowl. So the bowl, the ice, and the boiling, like, it all shatters. It all like explodes. It looks like nothing's happening, and then just poof, it falls apart. That is essentially what this show is. Like, it looks like nothing is happening. Like, you see little cracks and little things happening, and we, of course, are pointing out either the poor writing, the poor adaptations, the fundamental misunderstanding of Chief, the Spartans, and what the USNC is, and what Cortana is, and all of this stuff. But the show itself has still not entirely exploded. And I have a feeling in the next episode, it probably will. Because there's nowhere to go. Like, they have drugged their feet so long that they either need to crap or get off the pot. Like, that is sort of where we have arrived at.
It feels like this series should have been four episodes. Because basically nothing's happened. In fact, right, if in the end of the first episode, they hadn't escaped, we could be in the same place. Like, story-wise, that's all we know. And they could have... I think they've seen a circle and they've now got the name Halo. They could have come up with some reason to get that from the device itself, and we would be at the same place as now. It's insane.
Yeah.
Oh, exactly. Yeah, 100%. Yeah. They knew that it's too deep into the show to not fucking say Halo by now. But yeah, instead of coming out with a clever way of like saying it, they're like, oh, fuck, let's just throw it out. You just throw it out there, you know?
That's exactly what happens. She just throws it out. Yeah, yeah, you're right. There is that little, and she says Halo. And the way she comes up with the word Halo is just ridiculous.
Oh,
sacred
that entire
ring.
Scene.
Halo! It reminded me of, do you remember in the Han Solo movie where he goes, oh, what's your name? Han, last name. Oh, I don't have a last name. Oh, so you must be Solo.
Yeah, that was terrible. I've not seen that movie, but I've seen that clip. And that was so unimaginative and so insulting to, well, everybody, but especially George Lucas. Like, there's certain stuff you don't need to know. Like, you don't need to know. Like, we knew that he was a smuggler, that he had, you know, the fastest ship in the galaxy. Okay, cool. We don't care how he, like, came up. Oh, well, I won it in a poker game, right? And then that's when you meet Lando. And so we already have that sort of repertoire built. We don't need any further explanation. I don't care that he only had a first name. Like,
well, you also had to, we also had to eventually learn, as an aside in that show, that Lando likes to fuck robots too. You know, it's important to these people that we know every aspect of these people's lives. That Lando fucks a robot. Yeah.
The thing is, if you make a sequel, you have to create something new, which requires talent, and it's far more difficult.
Come on!
If you go back in a prequel, you're taking credit for somebody else's work because now you're saying, "Well, I basically made this."
Mm-hmm. Come on!
It's just somebody else's. Yeah, that you've taken this really popular thing and going, "Actually, no, I laid the foundations for that." And from people who are in later generations, they'll probably watch it in order. Like, who watches one and then goes back in time? So they will see your stuff first and probably think that you made it.
And this is the thing. And this is a bigger issue, and this is, I'm throwing this at Paramount right now specifically, but you're gonna see it happen everywhere. They're gonna do it with Star Wars with the Old Republic as well. Lethal looks hot all the time. Like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
This is true.
I like that that interrupted your flow. You saw it, let's get to
I'm just like, what the fuck, you know? Paramount is now gone back with Star Trek, and they went back with Discovery, and it was a bunch of fucking problems and a bunch of canon issues. And they said, don't worry about it, blah, 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 blah. The canon is important to us. The original series. They're remaking the original series.
Yep.
And they're not telling you they're remaking the original series. They're going, well, no, these are the adventures of Captain Pike and his crew. But they are literally recasting old characters that were in the original series. The only difference is that Kirk doesn't show up until season 2. But what makes you fucking think that they're not going to redo the original series now? Because now the lore, the canon, all of it belongs to them. They'll rephrase history, change it, make it look like they want it to look, and then tell you this is Star Trek now for a new generation so that nobody will go watch the original old shows. So that way they can control history with that, and they're going to do the same thing with fucking Star Wars, and they're doing the same thing with Halo now. They're telling you, this is Halo. Mail,
fuck your lore.
Fuck your lore. Yep. It's, what do you this think is, of, this is Halo now.
D.H. Halsey over here. Seriously, I think D.H. Halsey's just longer hair. That's it. That's all I did.
Looks so fucking ugly.
It's just longer hair.
Fucking piss!
She's about 6 foot in the background, and that's just makeup on her face.
Those cheekbones, though, man. That's all it is. It's just that's long just hair. They pushed their cheekbones out. Like, Dr. Halsey had a real bad Botox shot the other night and just come in like, it's all good, John.
Fucking
And we made a point of this last week, but in actual Halo lore, they're like, dude, do not fucking lie to these Spartans, because if they grow up, find out we lied. And they will find out.
Yeah.
Because we can't hide this. They're going to freak out.
In the fucking lore, they flat out tell you this. Yeah. They're like, you don't understand. These guys will fucking destroy us all.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
And the thing is, like, Spartans, the way that they're programmed, like, that was another issue that I had with the very first episode when she's like, so you just follow orders? No, like, they follow lawful orders. So the way that Spartans are made to tick is that they have a tactical brain equivalent to a supercomputer. They see movement on the chessboard based on the pieces that they have. And if a move doesn't make sense, then they know they're missing a piece of information. So they're going to go find that piece of information. And if you are the one holding that information from them, or you lied to them about that information, you're dead.
Yep.
So here we have Halsey outright lying to John, which kind of fundamentally breaks their whole relationship, which is supposed to be going forward. They're supposed to see Halsey as kind of a closest thing they ever really had to a mother figure.
Mm-hmm.
And she kind of uses that to take advantage of them in her own
way. That's why she's like, he's like, you're so special. And later on in the episode, she's like, he's always been special. I'm like, what about him? Why? Tell us. Don't just say he's special and like, I've just had a feeling in my water since he was born.
In this, it's going to be because he's a blessed one. Whereas like in the lore. But and they do know? Actually show it a little bit. No, she hasn't shot it. She doesn't know it at this stage. She can't.
She's telling him he's special, though. So yep. There should be some reason that makes her think he's special.
And that's the thing. This is the thing, too. You know, in Halo canon, if they actually fucking gave a shit, which they don't, John is special. Like, they all, that's always been a thing. He's unique because he's lucky. He always kind of like, he passes his test. He kind of just has like a natural like leadership ability about him that everybody's always looked to him about. But they don't explain that in this. She just kind of goes like, oh, you're just special. Like, I don't know. There's just something about you, John. And you're like this percent. What? Something. Give me something.
The thing is, when you say something like, there's just something about you, usually that's backed up by something. Like, when they're like, what do you mean? What is it about me? Is it like, it's just like...
Is it my hair?
Okay, we're gonna get sappy for a second, but this show got sappy, so you can blame the show. But the thing is, like, when someone's like, I love you, and you're like, well, what about me do you love, right? And then they're like, is it my hair? Is it my eyes? Is it my personality? Is it my attitude? Like, what is it about me? And then that person that has said that they love you will pinpoint whatever it is. They're like, well, you know, like, I love how when you get angry, your eyes change color, and you just really love, like, you fight for what you believe in, like something of that nature. You can like back it up, but when you say there's just something about you that is special, you're being patronizing.
When you break my wrist, it's really hot.
It didn't break his wrist.
You know what, Lady Gravemaster? Let's be honest here. You beat the holy hell out of this guy, and you're just being really humble about it. And that's fine. She's like, oh, I use the momentum against him. I, you know, really what she did was she grabbed the guy. She broke his wrist.
She's doing the stream. Yeah. She's just like pinning him.
The guy's like on the ground right now crying. And she's like, when the stream is over, I will let you go. Yeah. If you don't lose consciousness before this.
So what you're saying, Lady Greymaster, is that this guy to the right of the screen is looking at Halsey and thinking everything you just said.
Yeah,
pretty much.
creepy, rapey scientist who just kind of stares at Halsey.
I'm going to go home and make the Eiffel Tower yourself.
Yeah. I'm going to do the weirdest shit to your clones. God, I don't want to see his fucking face anymore.
Yeah, can I just say, and this is nothing against the gentleman himself.
It's everything against him.
But he's not that. Master Chief. Like, just like he doesn't have that he just looks dumb, and I mean actually stupid. Like, he doesn't look like he has intelligence and cunning and determination behind his eyes. He looks bored, he looks aloof, and he looks unfocused, and those are not Master Chief. It has nothing to do with the physicality of the man. It has to do with the way that he emotes. He doesn't carry himself like Master Chief. His face does not express what you would expect Master Chief to express. Master Chief should be so intense that you can practically see his response, his visual, like what his face is doing underneath his helmet. That is how intense it should be. You should be able to look at the way that he is carrying himself, the way that he is looking at you, the mannerisms that he holds, and you should be able to determine the look that you are getting under the helmet. We don't even have the helmet in the way, and he's not able to do that. There's no emoting. There's no nothing going on.
I'm sorry, but we have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. Yes. We have a winner. Looks like Adam Sandler with the dance.
Yeah, that's pretty accurate, honestly.
You win. I've said it before, but I feel like what they've come up with here is an original character, and they've just slapped the Master Chief name on him. At this stage, he's been not only out of the helmet, but out of his armor, his Mjolnir armor. He spent more than 50% out of the Mjolnir armor of the show. Yep. But this is just 100%. Munted, man.
Also, can I just say that... Disparu, I know you've brought this up, and I'm just going to reiterate your point. I'm not going to take credit for it, though, like these people at Paramount writing prequels. This was Disparu's point, I think, 2 episodes ago. Can they please determine what the magic triangle actually does? Because this thing is still, like, it's still just undefined.
It, right? on the last screen, they're going, oh, it's got intelligence. So now the reason is, whatever it does is because it's essentially sentient and it decided to do it.
Yeah.
That's their great reason for it.
Yep. Like, and I'm sitting there and I'm like, okay. So if it's, and like I sat there and I was like, but like, what does it do? Like, it has to have a purpose. Even sentient, like, we're sentient beings. If you don't have a purpose, you're absolutely shit. So there has to be a purpose for why it's doing what it's doing. It's not just going to wake up and be like, oh, I'm going to, you know, give this guy super strength or super intelligence or whatever the hell it is. Like, you don't, sentient beings don't make decisions like that unless there is a stated goal or a stated purpose. And so this thing is still just an undefined thing. That and happens to have consciousness.
And there comes a point with technology where even no matter how advanced you say the technology is, it just becomes stupid. Yeah. Like, even when you get into Thor and stuff, there are limits to his power. Whereas this is like, it brings back memories. It's an EMP device. It's sentient. It can repair things. It can give your ship energy as well as take energy. Like, mm-hmm. Where is the list going to stop? Although yep. The best thing that I saw was in the Night's Watch review where they started calling it a toilet seat. And I can't not see it anymore.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
That's and what about cool. How like it has like the flashback to when John's a kid and he draws a Halo ring? That is just the stupidest shit in the world. You got to remember, man. When they find the Halo ring in the first Halo game, it's a total accident.
Yep.
And they're like, "What the fuck is this?" But this is like, I drew it when I was a kid. And then you have that other chick, Spartan Kai. I learned her name this episode. Yeah. And she's like, it's a Halo.
Well, that's the thing. Like, it's like the whole thing. I mean, even the Covenant, they know what the thing is to an extent, but even they don't really know what it does. Like, it's all like everybody's figuring out what the fuck is going on as the games progress and stuff. And in this, yeah, it's Halo. You're like, what? Why would you? What? Yeah.
If you don't know what the device is, would you take it back to your main headquarters where all of your leaders are? What if it's a bomb? What if you plug it in and it just explodes because you don't know what it is? Mm. Or whatever energy you're putting into it doesn't work well with
the
it, so it just explodes.
USC seems to just let anything in. Like on that episode 3 where they have the Uncle Mackie. I was going to have to call the Uncle Ruckus for the Covenant. If someone said that in the chat once, that's just stuck with me. when they just let her on the ship with like no containment, nothing, they just let her on. And then everyone ends up dying. Like, you kind of all deserve that, even though it is all bullshit.
Yeah,
like,
I think
the research bases and stuff.
Like,
on
there's so much. I mean, I'll go ahead and say it. Friggin' Alien and Aliens are a perfect example about why certain space protocols exist. And when they're not adhered to, when someone keeps something from the rest of the crew, or somebody tries to smuggle like an alien artifact or something like that for greed or whatever. It never, ever pays off. God, this bitch and her haircut. I hate her.
Yeah, but it's shaved on both sides. That makes her double powerful.
Double powerful. See, this whole Quan, Queef, Soren, Psy plot that's going on, holy fuck, get rid of it. Throw it in the bin.
It's literally just
Mother.
Take up time.
That's what you've done. That's what you've done. You're in the bin with Mother. This is what you've done to yourself.
Oh, I hate it. There's no point to it. It as far as I can tell, it adds nothing to the overall story. It adds nothing to the overall plot. There's no character development from them whatsoever. And it's literally, she's just to fill space. These are 1 hour episodes. You have a lot of time to, like, we should be so much further into this story than we are. And it has basically just been exposition and telling Chief that he's special, but also a piece of shit.
She's going to be the one through which all information comes from, because they're setting it up now with this sort of, her father was involved with a cult, essentially, who knew all about the device. And they're going to set it up so she's the blessed one and saves the day. And she discovers all the information about it and then goes to Master Chief and tells him what it is because he doesn't know. He's just a stupid man in a suit at the end of the day.
I like it how when she finds out about it, her aunt's like, oh, your dad went to talk with the desert people. It's like, bitch, the whole planet is a desert. We're all desert people here. He went to talk to some guy in the city. We're all in the fucking city.
Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. what's your... What's your fucking
I will
point?
Say, like, I didn't mind this part here with Soren getting his memories back. I like that, where he's like, yeah, I killed my dad, it turns out. I remember doing that. That was cool, whatever, but it's never touched upon again. You could have done... See, there's times in this show, especially with that Visher character, where they start doing something where I think, okay, you could do something well here. You could elaborate on this, and they just never do. Mm-hmm. It's like the show is scared to actually have a story that just goes, butt cheeks.
Yeah. Well, no, they don't have a story, so they just are going to throw shit at the wall. Because if you have a filler episode, your second episode, that tells me you don't have a good story. You don't have – you're saving it all. You're saving it till the very end, and you're going to blow your load in the last episode and go, wasn't that awesome? And you go, no, because the rest of the show sucked. So even if – let's say the last episode is amazing, does it make the rest of the show good?
Yeah, no, they're leaning too much on it's not how you start, it's how you finish. Well, you have to get started so you can actually finish, yo.
Yeah. Foreplay. Like, yes.
There you go.
Boom.
Foreplay. Fucking nice. Foreplay. Best example.
So many naked
fucking, you fucking dogs.
But that guy is talking about his memories, and he's talking about years for that pill to wear off and when he got his memories back and remembered the next thing. But for everyone else that takes out, it's instant. The moment that pill's out the back, they suddenly feel and everything's normal again.
Magic.
Magic. So this part was weird because she cuts the pellet out of her ass, basically, right?
And that woman herself. Doesn't know.
Yeah, she doesn't notice. She doesn't notice the fucking knife right in front of her. If anything, she should be able to see the knife in the reflection of the mirror.
Well, there's a big gaping wound in her back. It zoomed
yes.
in on it. And
it's yes!
Obvious
fucking,
there's a big gaping
there's
wound
a hole.
In her
There's Giant a hole in her back!
Yep.
And it's like covered in blood as well. It's like, you'd be like, what on earth has just happened to you?
Yeah.
And from the way it's described it, these pills are like really important to them. They're like UNSC rules. And if that comes out, they'll start getting their memories back and then we'll lose control of them. So they'd be terrified of them doing that.
Yep.
And plus the fact it's so obvious that she's taken a pill out. But what I don't get about this part, apart from everything Despero just said, spot on. But remember when Cheeks was cutting out his pill, right? He couldn't see what he was doing because, you know, it's just above his own ass. So he can't really see what he's doing. He needed Cortana to stand behind him, and she was going, you know, 1.2 centimeters to the left or whatever to direct him. Whereas she's just got a knife going, yeah, fucking wherever you get out there, you bastard.
Not only that, but when Chief does it, Halsey is watching him do it. And it's not because of Cortana. She's watching him because they monitor the Spartans. Did they just forget to watch them? Like, Chief left, they're like, the other three will be fine. Fuck it. Who gives a fuck? Nobody else.
The other three insanely loyal to Chief Spartans will be totally fine.
Who, like, also, actually just recently stepped into them in front of a military operation where they're trying to take out Chief. They went to defend him, and they're like, whatever, fuck it. We're not going to talk about it. Like, go ahead.
And I don't understand why everyone's getting stalkers just to take something out of their lower back. Like, at most, you'd kind of take your t-shirt
butt
off and lift up your t-shirt.
See what I mean? Like, it's just flat. Like, they have her arching her back for it. Like, so they had her thrust her pelvis out and they like turned her a little bit so that they could get like contour and stuff. And they're using the shadows and the lighting, but like, she has no ass.
She just throws the pill into the sink and leaves it there for anyone to
find. Yes, so I thought that too.
And someone comes in to just wash their hands and go, what the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
One of the Spartans has gone rogue. It's like, they zoom in just in case you don't know what's just happened. They think everyone's stupid. Oh, look, no, she definitely pulled it out. And
there's no way that other Spartan didn't see it, man. Like, she's got the knife pretty much right there. There's a big hole in her back. Like,
yeah, and if you were in a bathroom and someone's washing blood off a knife in a bathroom, like, oh, what's just happened to you? You'd think they'd done something like they shouldn't be doing it. Like, it becomes very important.
They equate no emotions with like being completely oblivious to the world around you. Like, that doesn't make any sense. That's not how that works. Like,
nope.
You'd become logical, like super logical.
So you go, hey,
put it together faster.
Exactly. They'd be like, why the fuck? And then, you must be doing shit that you're not supposed to do. That's not cool, you know, but no, that's not. Yeah.
And just how obvious it is that she's taken out her pellet as well later
on. It's so fuck. Oh my God, dude. And everybody's just like, this is fine.
I still maintain that what they were actually trying to do was some form of like birth control or something, and to like try and control the hormones down there, because otherwise you would put that as close to the, like, you would put that as close to the brain stem as you possibly could. Because
did you say that? It sterilizes them, that pill.
Yeah. So like, I still maintain that that pill was to like sterilize them and cut off, like, especially for like women being more like of the nurturing type or whatever, they're basically trying to cut off like the urge to reproduce or the ability to reproduce, essentially, because if you cut off a man's testosterone, like, he's going to like, he's not going to want to fight. These are soldiers. You need them to fight. So like the pill makes no sense at all, no matter how you look at it, but I'm still maintaining that it has to be some form of birth control.
And then, like we said in the last episode, for someone like Chief, who's as old as he is, right, skipped all the teenage puberty bullshit because of Spartan, the silver timeline, Spartan 2 program, you take that pill out of him, he is going to be the horniest dude on the whole galaxy. And what could possibly go wrong there?
He was horny.
Lady Greymaster's out here pinning motherfuckers to the ground. Imagine what he's going to be doing.
As soon as that peanut butter shot wore off, she was like, I'm going to go beat the shit out of somebody.
Yep, that's what happened.
My theory is that fucking Lady Greymaster looked at this dude's wife and said, mine. And this dude was like, what did you say? And then she had to, like, you know, lay the smack down.
She's like, sorry.
I would not want anything that man calls his.
Yikes.
Did you
hit
him
with his wrist, apparently.
Except his wrist. So here we have Chief, helmet off again. Why? Why? I mean, how many shots have there been throughout the Halo games where he's looking out a window with his helmet on? But not helmet off here. But they do a big troll. They do pull a troll. Oops, they do pull a troll job here. So he puts his helmet on, or as Disparu calls it, the bike helmet.
Yep.
So that way they can go driving. Yep. They get in their Warthog. They go cruising. How bad did that look? I didn't even notice that.
He specifically puts it on as he gets into the car, and then as he gets out of the car, immediately takes it off. It's just for the car ride.
That's trolling. I didn't even notice when I watched it how fucking bad that looked.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What was the budget to the show again?
A lot.
10 million an episode.
10 million an episode, dude.
Yeah.
Mate, someone like fucking... Someone like Cell Shade.
Star Trek has better looking chips.
Cell Shade could make that.
Yep.
You know, like, Cell Shade's good at what he does, but this is supposed to be a $1 billion corporation.
Yep. Yep.
Fuck, you know. Cell Shade, you can get a job with these dickheads, man.
Yeah, you could. Fucking Disney did it. They did such a bad CGI job on the show that some guy on YouTube was like, I could do better. And they're like, you're hired. Also, how fucked is it that Master Chief's helmet has the dock for Cortana on the back?
I noticed that as well in this shot as well. They literally have the dock for him to put the chip into his helmet.
Yep.
But instead they drilled it into the back of his head.
Yeah, because Disparu doesn't know that about it. But that little slot, there's like a circle with a slot in the back of his helmet. In the show, in the game, Cortana is on a chip that he plugs into the back of his helmet. He can take her out and plug her into computer systems. And that's actually where she gets, like, when she appears to Master Chief, he usually is in her hand, in his hand.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so he can talk to her and see her. And then he can plug her into computer systems. She can manifest herself.
She'll like hack it or whatever.
He's in the back of his skull and she just appears wherever she wants to.
I guarantee you they had no idea that that's what that slot was for.
And yeah, they copied the suit off the game or something, and they just immediately copied the port and didn't know what the port was for. But that also makes far more sense, because my question has always been, okay, she's supposed to be this advanced AI with loads of computing power. Where does she get it from? If it's in the suit, you can say it's in the suit. If it's in his brain, because I had a comment and it's like, you do realize that that chip in his brain is essentially a computer. I'm like, yeah, but size matters with computers. So if you're saying that's super powerful, a mobile phone to them would be even more powerful than that. So it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Yep.
You're saying that a brain is the most powerful computer, which we know there's a limit to what your brain can do. And she's still manifesting in the middle of a room. Like, she manifests in the middle of a room and we don't know who can or can't see her.
I think everyone
She's like, she's like Brian and Stewie from Family Guy. Who knows that they can talk? Like, do they just like, can anyone else pick up the fact that they're talking or what?
But that's a good point. It assumes that everybody can see and hear her, but how?
Like, there are times in this where it's clearly she's talking in her own head, but when she's a hologram, everyone's supposed to hear her. But wouldn't that voice be coming like out of his face?
Yeah.
So you'd have a picture over here and the voice from over here.
Yep.
Because you can't project a voice.
Holy shit! The more you think
about
it,
you can throw your voice. Like there, so there's different techniques. You can throw your voice, but I guarantee you that Master Chief has not practiced theater, has not gone to theater and been trained how to throw his voice around.
Of course not.
He's too busy fighting aliens.
Well, and the chip would be the one generating it.
Yeah. Yep. So yeah, it would. It's just ridiculous. Actually, Abomination, or I know you're trying to say Abomination, but in the chat says, they said they went to 343 to get the entire canon. No, no, no. They said they went on a pilgrimage to 343. They tried to make it sound far more epic. Yeah, they got lost. And I'm like, that's why I said, I was like, when you say you made a pilgrimage to 343, what do you mean by that? Did you go there? Did you stand outside the doors? Did you sit and listen to these people that you don't actually respect?
They just drove around the building a couple times and then went back to the office.
That's it. That's the building. All right. Got it.
Yep.
Got it.
We nailed it, guys. We know Halo now. We get it.
I think you're spot on, though. They just looked at the design and went, okay, there's supposed to be a slot on the back of the head. And they're like, okay, cool. You know?
Yep. And because at this point, if they move Cortana out of his head, it doesn't fucking matter anymore. They've already fucked up the whole thing.
He just put the helmet on to go for a drive. His bicycle helmet gets off the car. Takes it off straight away, man. What the fuck? They got trolled, man. I respect the control. That's
and
a
he
troll.
Doesn't know that this area is safe. This is an area none of us have been to. It's been quarantined. There could be anything over here. Just immediately takes it off.
Jackal sniper. Bang. Dead.
This would be no different than someone in the military going to an area they've never been to before and just taking off their armor plate. It's like, oh, I'm probably fine.
So
it's fine. It'll be fine.
They've gone to John's old home because he has all his memories in the last episode. And he's like, oh, there's a second artifact. And if I go back to my old home, I'll be able to figure out where it all is. Okay. Because, Like, you're going to remember something. I don't know. Did I bury something when I was a kid? I can't remember. But he can. And he's having all these memories. Now, I was wrong. I assumed that they were going to make his parents into like, I thought they were going to make his dad like a wife beater or some shit. They didn't do that. But what they did do, the way this explains it later on, to me, it sounded like his parents sold him out to the Spartan 2 program. They're like, hey, come take the kid. Fuck him. Come, because Halsey's sitting in their house. Whereas in like the actual Halo canon, Halsey and Key, well, mostly Halsey, Keys is in the background, but Halsey confronts John while he's playing with other kids. And she's like, and she, in her mind, she's like, I'm finna kidnap you, eh? And then, you know, he makes him do the coin toss and he guesses the coin toss right every single time. And they do it in this, but it's in his home. So it's like, so Halsey got into his home somehow. And I don't see how that could have happened unless John's parents let her in.
Well, this entire colony goes, remember, because they said, oh, there's a plague or something on it, and the entire colony got destroyed. So
see, I think
happened,
what that is that's a little hint to, or maybe an Easter egg to the flood maybe coming into the show.
Yeah, but it'd be a bit coincidental if the parents sold him out and then the entire planet got destroyed.
Yeah.
So I think Halsey's got something to do with it.
Shit, we'll see.
Because I think Halsey's wiped out the planet essentially, and just take the.
I think just Bruce giving Paramount too much credit.
Yeah, you're too smart.
Well, now he's just thinking like, if you do a good story, this is what you would do with that fucking story, and Paramount's like, man, am I going to disappoint you? Yeah,
this is me pulling out the most cliche bullshit I can think of.
Can I go one cliche further?
Just throw me on the ground. Well, actually, if you're going to throw him in the ground, do it hard. So,
his mother is going to be so distraught that they sold John out, or father or whatever. Like, they're going to be so distraught that they try to, you know, they try to create something to, like, get him back, to, like, trade for him back, some kind of weapon that can be used against enemies, and then they accidentally wipe out the planet over their grief from losing John.
There you go.
Yeah. Holy shit.
Except the father will do something. The father will be one that causes the outbreak.
Yes, it'll be the father.
It's pretty munted. It's pretty munted. So here we have Visha, who, again, I think is probably the best character in this whole thing. I still think you could do something cool with this guy, but every time they get close to doing something cool, they throw butt cheeks at us. I like the idea of him being a UNSC plant to control the planet, but that's supposed to be an Oni type thing. I'm never going to get off this Oni trip. I know Disprove's already over it, but I'm never fucking getting off this Oni trip. There should be Oni in this show. So here he is walking around. You know, I'm a villain, motherfucker.
Yep.
And he's got his
who walks like that.
Also, what I don't care is why didn't he walks to the car to get picked up, but why didn't the car drive to him to pick him up?
Because they wanted this scene. They wanted all of them walking in an arrow formation.
They wanted to get the shot.
A distinct image of mid-century Germans. That's all set up for that. They're obsessed.
And this is the thing too. Like, you know, I don't know. I don't remember what Game of Thrones' budget is for per episode, but you know, they had a lot of money too. Tell me a time where you see a scene in Game of Thrones, or even there are shows that you see now that where it looks like an obvious set, and like even this here, the framing, the lighting, everything, it looks like a shitty set for like a shitty sci-fi show. It doesn't look like a big budget television show that's supposed to immerse you into this world. It just looks like people like running around being busy in the background and shit. And then, yeah, the flying evil V.
Tell me that that doesn't look like that. Wait, dude was walking? That's called the princess walk.
I am a princess, you fucks.
Look how like, fucking beautiful.
That's how he's
I am.
Walking. You got off of that scene, but that's on, me, like that's literally how he looks.
Let me go back to it.
Look how
like,
fabulous.
Tell me
I am.
That look at that. So look at that.
Yeah.
And then go back to that. Tell me that that's not like her arm is slightly more forward, but that's essentially the same walk.
Oh, I am Princess Vrisha, you dogs. Is that a golf cart? I kind of think it is. Actually.
It is.
I want to know what this one on the fucking left is. What the fuck is that thing?
Oh, that looks like you know those airport things they carry around?
And it's got the luggage on the back?
Yeah. That's what that looks like. It just doesn't have the trailer that you can't see.
God damn it.
Oh my god. Yeah, 2552, boys and girls. We got fucking makeshift luggage carts.
Yeah, there's only one scene in this where one of the vehicles, just through coincidence, it looks like it's hovering because the wheels are at the back and the camera hides the wheels. And it's the only thing that looks futuristic out of everything I've seen.
Yep.
So, yeah, like, again, because you go back to the first episode and they basically just had, like, Toyota, they had Toyotas and Chevys with turret guns mounted on the back.
Yeah.
Like,
yep.
What are you doing?
It's so not making bad. A good show, apparently.
But here we have Soren and Quan. I've just forgotten her name for a second.
Well, everybody does. It's okay. Yeah.
It's okay. Don't feel bad.
It literally looks like he's put a bag over her head because of the shape of that hood.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it probably would have been better if he just done that.
It's a better disguise. Yeah. My favorite thing in this, she's like, oh, we've got a disguise. And she pulls her hood up to disguise her. The moment she sees someone, just pulls it down. She's in the
middle public.
Of the, yeah. Yep. Everyone surrounding her immediately pulls it off. And there's a poster. And... there you go. There's a poster right next to her of her face saying wanted. And she's just got a hood down.
She might as well just be posing next to it, being like,
yeah.
Can we also,
who could I be?
Can we also talk about how they. Why are they combining language? Like, It says reward, but then like the reward is in
whatever.
Like, first of all, that's not that's not Forerunner language. Like, what are you doing? Like, if anything, it should have been like 16 posters in 16 different languages. You know?
Yeah,
what I mean?
That would make more sense than just mixing.
But
it all
instead,
off into
one. they have inconsistent language on a wanted poster, and so
yeah, well, don't forget that her and her dad like spoke Chinese to each other.
Yeah.
Or whatever language, you know, in the first episode, implying
with Chinese accents.
Yeah.
Like when they spoke English, it's absurd. This whole show's premise is absolutely absurd. And it's proof that they have no vision for the future. They think that what we currently exist in is as far as we are ever going to be able to go.
Mm-hmm. But it doesn't make any sense with that as well, because we have spaceships.
Yeah.
Like, the spaceships, like, how did you get to the planet?
Yeah.
It's all munted.
It's garbage.
They're trying to downplay how
the
impressive it is
sucks.
That we've been able to grow to the point that we can literally cultivate the universe if we wanted to. But they're trying to downplay that.
Yeah.
But
now,
for
this is the scene everyone was looking for.
I never knew. I'm not sure the effect's right, but as you know, Guns Lady G, gun oil in your hair, it's going to be a bad time, isn't it?
Yes, very bad.
Nah, it's going to look fucking fabulous.
No.
Yeah. My thing is, yeah, her first response, her first thought, when she gets some individualism, she's like, I'm going to dye my hair pink.
But like, what?
She's like, well, I want individualism. This, I want to, my feelings.
The thing with her dyeing her hair pink, I feel that's the biggest fucking red flag that she's mm-hmm. taken out a chip capsule tablet
100%!
Thing.
Yeah! Nah.
Yeah, so fine. The thing is, like, when women... So, it's really common for women who've just gone through, like, a bad breakup or who are really stressed out or who are like, okay, I'm looking for a change in my life. What's the easiest non-permanent thing I can do to change? Because, and then they'll go get a haircut or they'll go dye their hair because... It is temporary. Like, your hair will grow back out. Your the dye will eventually fade, or you can dye it a different color if you don't like it. So that, but see, they're not, but Halo, the writers are not that intelligent. Like, what they're saying here is the only way you can be an individual is if you physically stand out. Yeah. Not through any other means other than physically separating yourself from the rest of the group by dyeing your hair pink or buzzing the sides of it or whatever it is. They're saying that this is what individualism is manifested on a physical level, but they aren't actually looking at the psychology of why women dye their hair or cut their hair or paint their nails or go spend, like, there's women they've gone through a breakup and they'll throw all but like anything that they purchased when they were with that person, they'll throw it out, they'll burn it, they'll throw it out, and then they'll go buy new stuff. Like, there's women that do that too. It's a very, like, women are, it's insane. That's why it's called retail therapy, is because you're chunking the old and you're going to bring in some new stuff, right? And it does actually serve as a coping mechanism, but there's a whole lot of psychology that goes into that, because a lot of the times there's no other way for a woman to, like, physically express herself, because in 9.9 times out of 10 in a fight, whether it be verbal or physical, women are going to lose. Men in general can get louder. They're far more aggressive. They're far stronger. They're much more intimidating, and they have, and I'm not saying that men don't have deep emotions, but I'm actually saying the exact opposite of that. Men's emotions are very, very deep. They're very rooted in who they are as a person.
Yeah.
And so they don't let them come to the surface very often. Women are the exact opposite, where a lot of times our emotions are literally right at the surface waiting to bubble over. And because we get frustrated, we're ticked off that we can't win the argument, we can't win the fight, we can't do this, we go to verbal sparring. And if, you know, we try to make them feel bad right before we leave, and then it's the mentality of, I'm going to show him what he's missing. And so you get rid of everything you had before and you completely change your physical appearance, even though you as a person may not have changed at all. You're trying to show the outside world that you're either over it or that you're better than him or whatever the case may be. So
yeah, you're like, look what
there's
he lost
a crap down, ton of psychology that goes into all of this, but that's not what this is about. This is about showing that now I'm a strong woman and I'm going to show you what I'm really made of. So I'm going to dye my hair pink. Also, gun oil doesn't work like that.
Unless you're the dude that got pinned on the floor. I mean, I get you about that one. That was funny.
Well, because I just thought, like, if this is meant to lubricate guns and, like, for bullets and stuff, I have no idea what it's used for. But I kind of thought it'd be a bit like
Gorilla
if you've
glue.
Got sort of the CPU paste and stuff. If you get that on your hands, it's everywhere. It's all over everything. It's not the kind of stuff you just spread about.
Correct.
Put on your head.
The purpose of gun oil is to prevent, so it does a couple of things. One, it allows your actions to flow more smoothly, so it prevents jamming. And so that's why you clean your weapon and then you make sure that it's well lubricated, so that the action doesn't get jammed. So you can prevent, you can help prevent a double feed. You can also help prevent, like, a partial, basically where, like, it gets hit, but then it gets stuck in your barrel, and then you fire again, and then basically your barrel explodes. That's another type of malfunction. So there's lots of different malfunctions.
Well,
that
that's a malfunction in a gun, but not,
yeah. So if you don't, if you don't properly take care, if you don't properly take care of your weapon, stuff like that can happen.
She's committed also to explaining this to us, and I'm making sex jokes the whole time.
Well, I mean, there's literally something in there called a buffer spring.
Yep, I have one of those too. Yep.
It looks like a dildo. But
Hey.
I mean, that's just, that is what it, but it's just what it looks like. Yeah. But its purpose inside of, if you have a gas operated weapon, it actually takes a lot of the impact. It takes the recoil so that there's far less of it. And so when you use the, when you're using your gun oil, you have to be, first of all, it's really expensive. And also the armory doesn't like giving it out. So when you use your gun oil, you use it liberally, but also cautiously, so you're not spilling it all over the freaking place.
Yep.
Because it's a limited resource. But yeah, it essentially, it prevents seizing of the weapon, and it allows the rest of the weapon to function the way that it's supposed to.
That's the toilet seat.
I can't unsee that now.
I've got a question, Lady Greymaster, but first, De Colin with €5, thank you very much, sir. We'll have to watch the replay. Hope you got into the stupid colonization analogy with all the white military corps suppressing the rebels of color. I think that part's about to come up. I think that part's about to come up.
The previous scene where the villain walks out, it's like, oh, that's all very uniform.
Now, my question, Lady G, is we talked about how Master Cheek's taking the capsule out, going to be a whole lot of testosterone running through his body and all that type of stuff, right? Do you think her taking the capsule out, she's going to have a lot of like sexual desires as well?
Depends when they put it in.
Is the bitch horny? Yes, Mike.
Yeah, my question. Most likely.
Yeah.
Because you can only like, essentially what happens is those hormones don't go away. Your body will possibly start producing less of them, but you're still going to have that initial buildup. And so essentially what's happened is you've basically, think of it like you've broken a dam.
Yep.
And so now all that shit's going to come forward. Hence, she went, yes, I can already tell you she's extremely emotional because she went and dyed her freaking hair.
Yep.
Yeah.
And presumably if you've not had like a certain chemical in your body for a while, you'll be more sensitive to it rather than if it's had been stable. So even a small amount would be far more stronger than it should.
Oh, this has got to be bad, isn't it? Oh no, I'm starting to realize where this is all going. This is bad. Really, really bad. Yep. But speaking of bad for me, this is the worst thing of the whole episode is my beloved Miranda. What did they do to you, sweetheart? I mean, how badass you were in Halo 2 and Halo 3, and you've been reduced to deciphering Sangheili languages, which later in the episode, it turns out you're fucking pathetically bad at doing and should be fired for your job.
I love that. It's so bad that the women are bad at doing things and the women have to help them do things better. Yeah.
Like, it's I know we're not there, but the idea that you can, like, if you point a gun at someone, the first thing they're going to go is AK-47. It's like, what? No one has ever replied that when a gun's been pointed. No one calls out the name of a gun when it's pointed at them.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll get to that. It's bad. It's really bad. But here we have, this one hurt me. We have Miranda Keys, right? She wants to keep investigating the whatever it's called in this, the fucking, I can't remember what it's called in this stupid thing. So she brings in the Spartan team that retrieved it. Honestly, I thought you would have done that before, but
right,
whatever. And the way when she talks to Spartans, she's intimidated by being around Spartans. Like, well, hell no. Dude, in Halo 2 and Halo 3, she's like, yeah, what up, Chief? How you doing, mate? Good to see it. What's up, man? Peace out, my boy. Catch you later, man. You want to go get a drink off the fucking earth, man? Like, she's like a badass, man. She hangs out with, like, actual Master Chief and talks to him, gives him orders and stuff like that. And then she's like, oh, Spartans. Oh, oh, you were created by my mom. I have mommy issues. Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, that's terrible. The other thing in this show, there is like, she's got daddy daughter issues and she's got mommy daughter issues. Like, that's not who Miranda is.
And she does nothing but moan about not getting free stuff. Like, every time she's asking for something, like, why can't I have this? Why can't I do this? And she talks as if she's the only scientist. I invented everything. I invented the shields. I invented this, and this. Like, there must be other scientists in the UNSC headquarters, but she's doing everything. Like, this is dog's body work. This is just put your hand on this and we'll get the results. Mm-hmm. She'd have somebody else to do that for her.
Nope.
My beloved Miranda. Look at what they did. Look how beautiful she was.
Look
in the
how
Halo
they massacred
remake.
My girl.
Look how they massacred
her. And then you've got her miserable face on the right.
Can you click on the one, the second? So it's top row and it's the second one in where she's like, got beautiful. That one right there. Okay. Do you see how perfect that haircut is? There's no flyaways, which are the tiny hairs that like that stick up on the top of your head or whatever. She has no flyaways. Her haircut is literally right in line with the bottom of her collar, which is within regulations. It's not eccentric. She looks incredibly professional. She looks put together. She's absolutely gorgeous. And she
professional.
Looks
professional. That's the word.
What?
Professional is the word I was looking
yes.
for.
She looks professional. She looks like someone who can get shit done. And like, she, it just looks
and
so
she does.
Good.
She's a bad, like, I will admit her line in Halo 3 is pretty cringe, that two war line, but that's just one shit line.
Yeah.
In a fucking amazing series. But then you get back to this and you're like, what the fuck happened here?
She looks, this individual who is not Miranda, like, we're just going to call all of them Nat, like, yeah. Not Miranda, she looks like she's on the verge of a temper tantrum every single time she talks.
She doesn't look like, you know how like in Halo 2 when they're chasing the Prophet of Mercy and she's like, nah, we're chasing him down for his ciggies is basically her attitude in that game. Yeah. This Miranda would not chase down a high prophet. She would not follow a high prophet into slip space. Whereas nope. in Halo 2, she's like, nah, I'm fucking catching this fuck one way or another. Nope. This is like, oh, Spartans, oh, please don't hurt me. Like, oh my gosh. And she is so fucking dumb that in this very moment, that Kai, I just remembered her name again, the one that took her capsule out, she says something that's pretty like a Spartan wouldn't say that. And she's like, are you okay? Like, it's pretty obvious she's taken out her capsule. Like, from yeah. the get-go, it's so obvious that she's taken out her capsule.
Couldn't fucking tell. Something's
especially
wrong.
When you compare her to the other two that are standing there. Like, even they're standing there. They're all standing there, you know, like, arms behind their back and all that. And she's just, like, you know, more relaxed and stuff like that.
Well, and their idea of her being, like, yeah, more relaxed is her pacing uncomfortably. And, yeah, I'm like, even you're still in the military. Like, mm-hmm. what, yeah.
Yeah. And just because you've got yeah. emotions doesn't mean you'll like lose all your training. It'll be habit that you stand to attention in a room.
Especially when you're doing it as a child.
Yeah.
A literal child.
Yes, your entire life, basically.
Yep. Lady G, you got to bounce. You got to go beat up some more people and steal some more bitches.
No, my manager, so like my supervisor said that I could take like an extra 15 or 20 minutes for my break. With everything
you beat
that
the shit out of the guy. Yep.
But well, like I'm fine. Everybody's fine. I'm fine.
Yeah.
But
the guy's not fine, but yes, I get it.
Well, I have to go talk to I gotta go talk to the police now. They just want to make a report. I said I wasn't gonna press charges, but they still have to file it. So I gotta go do adult things now. Not that this isn't adult things, tearing apart an absolutely horrendous show for the benefit of millions, hopefully. I hope you get millions on this stream.
Yes.
They're lethal so that they understand just how terrible and awful this show is.
I say that'd be more viewers than the show.
Yeah. but anyway, thank you for coming on. I'll get in touch with you because in the next week or two, we'll sort out time for Sailor Moon stream.
Yeah.
One
absolutely.
Of the mods, drop Lady G's link. But do you have anything you want to plug before you go?
Mm.
Apart from that dude's wife, of course.
Yeah.
I would say I don't really have, like, I don't have anything to plug. If you guys want to stop by my channel, I do live stream on Thursdays, but check out, I mean, Disparu has been killing it and Epic Mike, you make me laugh probably every 20 seconds. I just absolutely love watching your stuff.
Appreciate
and then of course, you know, check out all of Lethal's awesome content. He's really great. Absolutely adore him. So there's all of that. But, I'm just going to have to bounce. And if you are looking for a particular bang stick, I guess is what I will call it, because they don't like the other terms on YouTube. But if you're looking for a particular bang stick, I recommend starting with rifles over pistols so that you can learn proper stance, stability, and then moving to pistols. And then, you know, you can go have fun that way and learn how to properly use gun oil.
Boom.
Put it through your hair. Anyway,
yeah,
thank
you
for coming on.
And, all right. Thanks, gents.
I'll
speak to you
soon. Bye.
I'll see
you.
Have you ever had someone come to your stream before and be like, oh, I just bashed someone?
So calm.
Yeah.
But it's like,
I fucked this dude up
like
so bad.
Calm afterwards.
Yeah. I fucked this dude up completely. His whole world is over and his wife is mine. And we're like, wow, damn. And she's like, it's fine.
Yeah,
it was a very polite way of saying, oh, I just wrecked his fucking shit.
No. This guy had a really bad fucking day, and I'm the reason.
Because of me. I fucking
like
ruined it.
That she's like on top of him, and he's got his like arm pinned behind his back. He's like, no.
He's like,
fine.
Oh yeah, the
it's
cops
fine.
Are in here, and he's like, oh god, please let me go.
She's just like, restraining him until they arrive.
Yeah.
Just had to hold him on the ground. We're talking about Halo. But anyway. Yeah. So they're getting all the spines. They touch is it called a keystone or some shit in this?
Oh, they touch the pee-pee. Yeah, just
they're touching the toilet seat. They're touching the toilet seat, and none of them have an effect on
that
it.
That sounds gruesome.
They touch the toilet.
You want once a scene, you can't unsee it. It's impossible.
Yeah.
Oh no!
Putting their hand
so they touch
the
toilet seat, and none of them are activating it. See, that sounds even weird. See, none of them can activate the toilet seat because none of them are blessed ones. All right, there we go. I had to get that out of my system.
You're not blessed, and so you don't affect the toilet.
You kind of like, yeah. And here we have Master Chief digging a hole, which is pretty much all he fucking does. In
I love
this
it just says panting and grunting. That could be any seed in this.
It could be this dude in the back.
He's brought a Halsey with him.
He's just jerking off to a picture of like one of the Halsey clones. He's like, oh.
They just turn around and go, wait, Halsey, what are you doing back there? I thought you were over there. Oh my god.
I've got to say, this actor guy, he's meant to be in a suit that gives him super strength, and it's clearly pre-dug earth. I've never seen anyone dig a hole as bad as this guy. I really haven't.
It's really a skill at this point, yeah. I'm like, you're a fucking super soldier from the future. You can literally like pick up a fucking car over your head. And he's like, man, this fucking hole is really hard to dig. Holy
like 2 inches buried.
Yeah.
And he finds it. He brings it over. He opens it. And it's filled with pictures that he drew when he was a kid.
Why?
Because his parents are stupid.
Why did his parents, and they put it in a box. Like, why did you bury, if you're like, oh, these drawings are horrible.
Burn it.
Yeah. If you want to get rid of them, don't put it in a box which preserves the drawings.
Yep.
And it's not like they're anything special. Oh, we might need these again. No,
well, maybe he put them in the box. Maybe he did.
No,
it
the
himself.
Father did.
I know, father... but that's what I'm saying. Like, that's how like the little thought is put into it. They're like, yeah, they're like, oh, this is bad. Don't talk about this. And he's like, I'll put this all in a box and save it though, and bury it in my fucking yard.
You can picture the dad being like, they might make a show about us in 20 or 30 years. We should probably put this in a box.
Eventually, he'll probably dig that pill out of his back that I don't know anything about. So then he'll come looking for these pictures. Yeah.
Must have read the script.
Yeah.
He's read the script. Then we have Down Syndrome. What was it? Adam Sandler?
Adam Sandler, yeah.
Down Syndrome, Adam Sandler. Holy fucking shit, this part.
Oh, my God.
Right. So Queef and Soren go to the father's funeral because apparently all this time's passed and he hasn't even had the funeral yet. And
it's a few
the dude,
flies.
and I mean, like, if you were going to host a memorial, because you got to remember, this Vrisha dude that's taken over wants to completely wipe out everyone that was connected to this guy as an insurrectionist. There's even a bounty on his daughter. So why would you hold a memorial for that dude in a public fucking street? Not even in someone's basement or some shit. You're holding it out in the street where a bunch of cars drive up to it later and go, wait a minute, what's this? This makes no sense whatsoever.
Yeah, they're all risking their lives, mourning an insurrectionist and the guy wants rid of them. And then Quan comes along immediately after this and goes, is this all he gets? Like, they're all risking their life for him? The first thing she says to Sheep is this all he's worth? It's like, you don't even appreciate what people do for you. She wants everything given to her, and she just expects all of it for free.
And
this is the most unbelievable part of all four episodes, that anyone actually sees her and likes her enough to hug her.
And what about the fact that she just saw a bounty on her, and her main reaction is just to yell.
Yank off the hood and start fucking screaming at the top of her lungs, yeah. Yep.
And then she was that one of her aunts or some shit? Or no, that's not that her aunt. That this chick you're looking at right here, they tell you that this bitch was basically number two in the whole insurrectionist movement on Madrigal.
Well,
this
vagina,
old lady
is
number two in a fucking terrorist organization.
Yeah. She has a vagina, of course. She's the best at what she does, which is apparently nothing.
You know, I'm something of an insurrectionist myself.
It's really fucking good, actually.
Right. So yeah, apparently this bitch is fucking number two in a fucking insurrectionist movement against an overpowered military. But okay, fine, whatever. And Quan comes to the conclusion that she sold out everybody that's still in hiding because all the other like lieutenants and generals or whatever are being killed. And then, yeah, she goes on a full screaming fit and Sauron's like, you dumb bitch, you're about to get us all fucking murked.
Yep.
And then we're back with Miranda. And look, this moment here where she takes off her helmet and shows the pink dyed hair, that's the moment. That's the moment you press the panic button. Spartan's taking out its chip right there. Under the table, press the panic button. But oh, I studied military information. And she just goes on this full on. It's like the type of like, it's the type of speech a serial killer would give to one of its victims that doesn't know it's its victim yet.
Yes.
But also, she just mentions, oh, yeah, we know all of these languages, and there's no reason to mention that. It does not even to do with the scene. It's only done because you need to know they know languages for later on in the episode. It's the only reason it's mentioned.
Yep.
Yeah, and they get to that a bit later, and it's pretty bizarre. So John goes into his house without his helmet on.
He never has it on.
Oh, look at that!
He must have just got out of the car. Oh, no, it's... Yeah. Oh, is this this is the scene where he gets Cortana to give him images.
Oh my god, yes. Check this out. So he uses Cortana, and he's still pretty much an asshole to Cortana, and I can understand why. You know, she literally lives in his head.
And she wants,
to murder him.
Yeah. And the fact she wants to murder him as well. Yeah, that would do it.
At least she hasn't mentioned that this episode, so that was a bonus.
Yeah.
By the way, I want to kill you.
If it was up to me, your brain would be fried and I would take over your body. Yeah.
So she... I'm confused about what she did to, like, VR replicate what John's house looked like when he was a kid.
Cortana doesn't have the best cheeks, though, from that picture. Out of everybody.
Yeah.
Agreed.
There you go.
Boom. Agreed.
We see it now.
So, yeah.
Mike's like, I can't believe we've gone back for this.
No, it's all good.
Every episode, you got to talk about butt cheeks because every episode's about butt cheeks in some capacity.
They started it.
Yeah.
They
did start it, yeah. 100%.
Oh, this part here. So, he, like, sees himself. It's fucking weird. She's using, like, hologram footage in Master Chief's helmet.
Yeah.
So he can see how his house looked when he was a kid.
Yeah, and they're reconstructed from his memories. And the first thing he says is that table's in the wrong place. It's like, well, it's your memories that she built them from in the first place. How are they wrong? It doesn't even make any sense.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
he's remembering the table in a different place while she's getting the same memory and making it wrong. It's stupid. And then he starts having hallucinations. And she's like, yeah, I stopped projecting this into his helmet ages ago. I don't know what's going on. And he's there, like, stroking the air.
Yeah.
So imagine, like, Halsey and, like, the rapey scientist dude are just watching Master Chief in armor just...
Yeah. Our deadly killing machine is hallucinating. That's not a good sign.
That could go bad. And, see, he remembers that he, like, went into some cave or some shit. At least Halsey's starting to get a bit freaked out by this whole thing. And there's like some drama between... There you go. There he is there. Down syndrome, Adam Sandler. It's like some drama between him and his dad.
Yeah.
Oh, this is after he's gone to the back. And when she's doing the projection, he can't see into the back room. But when he starts hallucinating, then he sees into the back room. And that's when he sees Halsey and gets mad.
Yeah.
This is where it starts to get really funky.
Now, are these meant to be the elites on the table?
Yeah, that's supposed to be a thing.
Because they've changed color.
I might have missed something, but I think they're trying to say this one's like decaying. Or I don't fucking know. But yeah, it has changed color. Because there's let go worms in there as well. So, this is the part where you find out just how incompetent they've made Miranda in the show. Her job.
Not just Miranda, the entire UNSC. Not a single person thought of this for 20 years.
Yeah. So if your job was to translate the alien language, okay, and you have these Spartans that are on the front lines fighting these aliens damn near daily, who would be the first people you would ask about, hey, what have you heard them say?
Would their helmets record all the footage as well? At no point no one watched the footage back and thought, oh, they're speaking at us.
We can try and put this together. No one came up with this idea for 20 years until right now when Miranda has a light bulb moment. Oh, you guys see the Covenant day nearly every day.
And they even say, because when she picks up the gun, that's when they realize, oh, we know the name for Needler. But then one or the other goes, well, they may not say it's a Needler. They could just be going, please don't shoot us. It could be literally anything. And then they're just like, no, it's definitely Needler. No reason to think that at all.
You have the Covenant carbine in the background as well.
I actually love the idea that you could point a firearm at someone and they just say the name of it.
Yeah.
I think that's incredible.
Needler! Energy sword!
Yeah. Well, and then, like you said, yeah, the Needler's fucking massive. Like, you used to be able to dual wield them bitches in Halo.
I wasn't sure if that was oversized or not because it looked crazy to me. It's like the size of your entire torso.
I mean, the Spartans are bigger than regular people. So something that a Spartan could palm in one hand, most people would need 2-4. But the fact is, you should be able to dual wield fucking Needlers because they're not that big. I mean, they're like slightly smaller than a regular rifle. But I mean, like I said, in a human's hands, that's what they would probably look like in a human's hands.
Yeah, for like, if we held one, we'd probably hold it with two hands.
Yes, but because
it's image, that's where you really see the size.
Yeah, it's huge because they do that with, there's another gun in Halo. They actually deal with that in a Halo, in a fucking commercial of all things for Halo, where they show like a Covenant gun and a regular human's holding it. It's huge and heavy, but because a Spartan's so strong, they can hold it in one hand. Like, it's like a pistol for them. It's like 40K with like bolters and stuff. It's ridiculous. But they don't know. They don't understand any of this. You know, they don't think about any of it. Yeah, that's fucking massive.
Huge. Yeah,
and then they talk about the pink mist. Yeah, they talk about the pink mist, but the needles are green.
In fact, on her, that's probably from her waist to her head.
Yep.
Yeah. Probably. Yeah.
Yep.
And why do they keep needles in it?
Yeah,
that could just super combine if you didn't know what you were doing with it.
100%.
Blow up.
Well, that's the other thing. When they pick up the gun, this woman, I still don't know her name and I'm never going to learn it. She is scared of the Spartan holding the gun. And
yeah, like, Miranda,
well, she should know that it's not got any needles in it or whatever. It's not armed. And they also know how to use it because they've used them in the field. They're around them all the time. You're not going to be scared that your highly trained military operative doesn't know how to use a gun, but your scientist does. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. Yep. 100%.
Oh my God.
That's the shot. That's crazy size.
That is ridiculous, dude. That's like the size of her chest as well.
Yeah.
It's
at least
fucking
this one
huge.
Was colored in. But I mean, this is just another moment where you would very clearly be like, she's fucking taking her pellet out. The other two are standing like perfectly still, doing nothing, you know.
And once
this
again,
one's just walking around grabbing shit, talking about, fucking pink mist, bitch. You know?
Yeah. Well, and then once again, like, you know, the one guy, I don't remember his name now off the top of my head, Big Black Spartan.
The one that's the only one that seems to act like a fucking Spartan?
Yeah. He acts more like Master Chief than Master Chief. Yep. The one-liners, the stoicism stuff, and then even here he gets snarky at one point though, and you're like, what? Like, yeah,
Vanok,
yeah, he gets snarky at one point during this. Like, he gets like, yeah, something about dumbass questions, and I'm like, what? Why would you even like? I don't know. It's weird.
And then they talk about, you know, when like Halsey was training him, and they gave him all pets and shit like that. Halsey killed mine anyway.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm like, well, and they, what's funny to me is that because that's how they amount like military training, because they do that in military training for some people. Like, those are stories that they do, that they'll like give them a chicken and like they'll give them a chicken and they'll have to raise the chicken. And when they get old, like when the chicken, they've had it for a while, they have to kill the chicken. So they learn like detachment and stuff like that. But they probably heard that somewhere and was like, oh, that's military. So they probably did that with the Spartans too.
You know where they've got it from. Like, you're going back to military. I think they just watched Kingsman and they just copied that.
Yeah, that's very possible.
It's the same thing, except in Kingsman it's better because they did it with a blank. Like, well, we're not cruel for no reason. But it's,
I still haven't seen Kingsman yet. I've been told the first one's really good.
You'll fucking love it. Yeah.
Brad DL, I don't know if you were around, but a few weeks ago we watched a clip on stream of some Paramount Plus shill shit. It was like, what does Halo mean to you? And the black actor was the only one that seemed to have half an idea of what he was talking about, where everyone else was like, paycheck. Yeah. I mean, fucking don't say paycheck.
it's obvious that he's the only one invested in what he's doing Yeah. With any level of conviction, like he's actually trying.
See this part here. What other Sinhili words do you know? Like, why didn't you ask him this like 20 fucking years ago?
But also they don't know that one. Like they know the words, they know the audio that it makes, but they don't know what it is. They have no idea. And they even said it. And in this bit as well, they even go, I can't believe we've not thought about doing this before. So the script writer knew it was a stupid idea and just kept it in. It's like, oh yeah, as long as we point out how stupid it is, everyone will just accept it. It'll be like a little in-joke.
It's meant to be stupid. Type thing. Mara, if you don't mind, do you mind dropping Lady G's link? She had to leave a bit before. She had to go bash another person.
Yeah.
Back with fucking Quan and Soren. All this shit. Filler.
Why does he not get his shit back? I still don't know. Because he's going to. And then she's like, oh, we need to go and do this. We need to go and talk to my aunt. He's like, okay. Well, shouldn't you stop the people nicking your ship first? I don't get why a pirate lets people steal his ship.
Not only a pirate, an escaped Spartan too.
Yes.
Yep.
Because he says he can easily get them. He says, oh, because she's like, there's loads of them. He's like, yeah, there's just enough. As if, yeah, it's going to be fun. But it just does nothing.
My God. So, yeah, they go in to see the aunt. Oh, more butt cheeks. More butt cheeks. Here we go. Yeah. Vrisha butt cheeks. There you go. You can see some butt cheeks there.
See, I wanted Lady G to compare his against Master Chief's. We could have a butt off.
Oh, butt off. See, he's got like this whole villain thing going for him. You know, I smoke cigars in a pool naked and I have my female assassin come in and shit like that. We got to kill kids and all stuff like this and... And then every time he starts to be really, really cool, they just show butt cheeks.
Yeah, it's I still think this is the one
character. Sorry?
It's like four or five times in this scene. And just when you think it's over, he flashes them again.
It's like, more butt cheeks.
Yeah.
And even the way he stands up, it's like... the butt cheeks are like dead center of the screen as well. So it's not like a little thing you can't not notice it and all that.
Mm. And I've every seen time, the same think... scene in so many other things. Quite often, if there's... there's like there's a movie where there's the Pope and he's in one of these big baths and he stands up and you see the same thing. And then in Spartacus as well, the Stars series, there was loads of big pools like this where they were doing it. Everything seems to be taken from somewhere else.
Yeah.
I recommend the Spartacus show. A bit of a guilty pleasure.
Mm. It's a great show, actually.
And also his costuming is actually really fucking bad because like the way he walks around and stuff, he looks uncomfortable all the time.
So does
Master Chief. I agree with John here.
Master Chief walks like he needs to empty his trousers.
Yes, constantly. 100%. And I don't know if you guys have noticed the sound design, but every time a Spartan walks anywhere, they have these super heavy footprints. It doesn't matter what kind of ground or floor they're on. It's always like thadoom, thadoom, like everywhere they walk.
Yeah, it sounds like they're a Gundam just walking.
Yeah, because it's trying to show that they're heavy and big. And I'm like, you can do that without constantly having like Modern Warfare like footsteps everywhere.
They're so heavy and so big that they can just rip it off really nearly and put it back on whenever it's convenient.
Yeah. I also want to point out
the first episode, it has that Iron Man.
Master Chief in his armor, like walking around an old house that hasn't been touched in however many years or whatever.
Years or whatever. They'd probably break the floorboards.
Yeah, he weighs like 1,400 pounds or some shit like that. So, yeah. I think, he's super fucking heavy. Yeah, but they didn't think about that.
The thing that got me about that house is there's a tree that grows through the floor. It's like 30 years ago or something, or however old Master Chief is, and a tree grows through the floor. That's not what happens to houses. If I left, like... Because you're saying that the only thing that keeps a tree from growing through your house is if you're there, like, hacking away at the floorboards or it'll keep on growing through the roof. That never happens.
Yeah.
My butt cheeks about to happen. I do agree with John though.
Dude, the Master
Chief plays a good he plays a good villain. This guy, he gives off a good villain persona. I will give him that. The writing around him's dog shit though.
Yeah.
Yep. Sorry, Mike.
No, I was just gonna say Master Chief weighs 1,000 pounds in his armor. So like when he's walking around in a house, imagine just having a house that you haven't stepped in 20+ years. That's with in like that has a trees growing out of the floorboards, and then 1,000-pound thing just drops in and starts walking around in it. Yeah, and they're like, "No, that's fine though." Yeah,
that's and in fact, in episode 2, the other Spartan said, "Take your armor off before you come into my house, because I've just had the floors done." So they've already said how heavy it is, and they'll destroy floors.
Yep.
You're right. I forgot about that. So here we have more of my beloved Miranda being degraded and turned into a fucking dribbling retard.
We're just going to say linguistic terms and hope that nobody understands what they are so we sound clever.
Yep. Also, as a side thing too, real quick, just this is the thing. I just looked this up. Just because I want to double check something and I found something else. Disper talked about how like he looks like Master Chief walks around looking like he has to drop a massive load. Apparently, the armor that they put on him. Already. Yeah, he's just shitting his pants and he's just the armor that Pablo Shriver wears weighs 50 pounds. Oh, with all the plastic and everything. His armor, he said, weighs 50 fucking pounds. So it's really hard to walk around in it and do stuff in it. But I'm like, I know people that do cosplay with fucking Halo Master Chief armor and Halo Spartan armor that have done a better job and looks as good, if not better, than the shit in this show. And it doesn't weigh that fucking much.
If it can't be done,
your body, it should be fine.
My thing is, if it can't be done, don't do it then.
Yeah.
And if you really have to, if you really want to make the show and you're going like, this is just turning into a nightmare, fucking just do it animated then.
Yep.
Get the voices to come in.
It's only 3.5 stone. Like, people will regularly put on that and not have that much trouble.
Well, like Mike said, you go to like a Comic-Con and you see these fuckers walking around everywhere, like a Coke in their hand and shit.
You know, there's even a guy, I watched him, he's on YouTube. He makes like armor and shit like that. He talks about how they don't do long shots a lot of the Spartans, but the few times that they do, if you look down, their feet look like you can see the lifts in their shoes. You can see that they're not the actual height that they actually look like. He goes, it's really easy to fix that. He goes, and I'll show you how. And he just shows you how you make their feet slightly bigger so that it hides their lifts in their shoes. He's like, none of this stuff is hard, but that means that somebody that did the costumes for that didn't know how to make the armor functional for people wearing it. But these cosplayers know how to do it, and they're sitting at home figuring this shit out themselves. Man, you know, it shows you
they should just get Axel Braun. They should just go, fuck it, just make our costumes.
Yeah,
just make our costumes. They won't. We asked him that and he said they can't afford me.
Yeah. But it just shows you the lack of care that they put into all of their work, you know.
Skip the small detail on episode 3 at the 21:16 mark where Quan says that her family was on Madrigal before it was a colony. So how did they get there?
It's a fucking stupid
answer. That's a fucking good point. See, that's the thing with this show.
Oh, they're not doing that story. Oh, they are. They're going to do the UNSC came in and they made a call. Yeah. So they were the native people of the land and then the UNSC came around and that's why they're fighting.
Colonizers.
They're literally bringing in their own. Oh, that. As a Brit, it's like, I don't know why I have to have that shoved in every single show. But this isn't an American show. You're shipping it around the world. Why do I have to have your storylines in everything? It's ridiculous.
And not only that, but it's set in the future. Like but this is the thing. They hear race and they assume it must mean like black and white, not
human species.
Yeah, not human. And they hear things like colony and they think colonizers. And you're like, if you go to fucking Mars, you create a colony. Like you're not like killing the Martians. If you kill the Martians, that's not probably a good look, but that's not what that means. But the like terms and stuff don't mean anything to them. They don't understand, like, how you could colonize some place that people, you know, and it be, like, normal. It's like, no, they're actually, like, colonizing other planets. That's kind of the point. That's how this works. It's so fucking munted.
Going on with this, though, is, like, there's so much fucking wrong that you're bound to miss stuff.
Yep.
We've probably missed dozens of things that don't make sense.
Oh, yeah.
because there's just so much. But here, Miranda's being an idiot once again. And I still can't figure out how by this point that she hasn't figured out that this Spartan's taken the chip out, the tablet thingy.
Yeah. That,
it was obvious before, but by now, it's super obvious. Oh, that would have been a good disproof thumbnail.
Yeah.
So with that. And then, yeah, we're back to John. Fucking all John does in... Nah, Master Cheeks. His name's Master Cheeks.
No, it's not.
All he does in this episode is dig a hole and bitch to Halsey.
Yeah.
That's all he fucking does. Halsey should have slapped him.
He's just a fucking loser, dude. I don't mean that to like Pablo Shriver.
Right I now. Do. I've watched these interviews. He's a bit of a fucking dickhead.
Okay, well, then he's a fucking loser, too.
But I think
well, then he's doing a great job of acting because he's portraying himself and, you know, fucking shit, dude.
I think that we missed the part here where it was like, it shows Halsey in his house and they're doing the coin flip scene.
Yeah.
When really it's supposed to be at school. But to me, that did come across as, well, it must have been his parents. It must have been his parents must have somehow got in touch with the UNSC and said, take our kid away. We don't like him anymore.
Yeah, get this drawing, fucking...
He's fucking drawing weird pictures. We don't like him.
Yeah. Get him out of here. We can't take it anymore. Get this fucking kid out of here. He's weirding me out. He's freaking Luke out my
Skywalker.
Wife.
Luke Skywalker wanted to kill his nephew because he had bad dreams.
Yep.
Master Cheek's parents want to get rid of him because they don't like his drawings. They went through his drawings and went... Yeah. Nah, fuck this. I know a program that will take you.
Yeah.
But the thing is, we've had this kind of stuff in horror films loads where people start doing like demonic text and stuff and like, that's creepy. If he started writing an alien language that nobody knew, that would freak out his parents. But when he's just drawing circles, oh yeah, you just see a circle and lose your mind.
Yeah. What are you drawing a circle for? We don't have circles here.
But this is a square house, kid.
Yeah. If it was just writing like red rum repeatedly over page after page after page, his parents would be like, oh, what on earth is going on here?
Yeah.
Imagine that. They're like, you see our wedding rings? Squares, not circles. We don't do circles in this house.
You're munted. Yeah. Like
square wedding rings.
Yeah.
We don't do circles here. That's it. I'm calling Halsey. You're going away.
We gotta get rid of you. Yeah. You're out.
You're out. That's the new thing. Someone doesn't like you. Well, you don't like someone. I'm calling Halsey. You're going in the bin. You're going in the bin.
They put Master Chief in the bin. Oh fuck.
Oh, now here he is. He's trying to have his cowboy bebop moment. You know, this is a robbery, motherfucker. I'm stealing your shit.
Also, his. Go ahead.
He robs an innocent guy rather than going to the people which took his ship and going John Wick on them. It's like ridiculous. Yep. If this guy was John Wick, all he would have done is go, oh, I know you took out my dog, but I guess I'm going to have to go to the pound and steal a new one. It's like, that would have been a terrible move.
Yeah, you fucking killed my dog. Time to, I don't know, go rob a random citizen.
Yep. Yeah, just steal a dog off somebody else. I'm also, not going to take revenge or get justice, even though I'm a pirate.
His fucking gun looks straight up like a gun from Destiny.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It looks like, what is the last word from Destiny?
Yeah.
Which doesn't make any fucking sense, except they're like, oh, well, you know, Bungie. But like, yeah, go look up the last word from Destiny. Same exact fucking gun. Same design.
Is that a gun that actually exists, though?
Not in Halo. None of the revolvers.
I mean in real life. Because all the cars and stuff are just from us, so that might just be an actual weapon.
I've never seen a revolver look like that.
I've jumped too far ahead. You'll see it later when he comes in shooting.
Yeah, which doesn't make any sense because at one point he shoots his gun, runs out of ammo, drops the bullets. We'll get to that point. Oh my god, dude, this fucking show, dude.
So Queef goes to talk to her aunt. And her aunt's like, oh, yeah, fucking oath. See, in the trailer, I thought this was going to be Quan, but it was her dad. So,
it's trying to say he's evil.
Sorry?
It's trying to say he's evil. It's doing the bad dad story. Because before he was a good dad. Now he's a bad dad who got involved with the wrong people and just went around killing people.
Like, but they're saying, her dad went and talked to desert people when the whole planet of desert people is at the desert planet.
Well... these would have been the indigenous desert people that knew about that cave and probably worshipped it or something and had, like, secrets. They'll be the ones that know about Blessed Ones and what that device is and stuff.
And because they tell him, they're like, hey, you know, these guys are, like, the reasons why he started the whole, you know, rebel group on Madrigal.
And so, why that camp was there. Because I thought in the first episode, it's weird how, like, this cave just happened to be right next to a base. But it could be that he set it up there to protect it or something.
I mean, wouldn't you build around? I don't know. What do you think about it?
The show's fucking munted.
Mm. It's fucking retarded, isn't it? And then she's like, nah, your dad's trash. Which I'm assuming is her brother.
Yeah, your dad fucking sucks. He's terrible. Yeah,
no one liked him. We were this close to calling Halsey on him, I swear. I love how Halsey's just become like the... You have a child that you just can't deal with anymore. You just call Halsey. You're like, fuck it. You know, instead of the, you know what? I'm calling Santa. No presents for you this year. Instead of that, it's I'm calling Halsey. You're going away.
Yep. Just flies, you gotta go in the bin. Look at Kwan and leaves.
Yep.
You can have a...
Yeah. You donate your vegetables. I'm calling Halsey. Yep. So yeah, basically she's like, yeah, your dad sucks. Everything was all bullshit.
Everybody hates your fucking dad. Like, you're like, what?
Yeah. I swear, this whole part to me, there it is there.
Like, that was insane. Did you see Kwan finds out that the woman's coming to kill her, and she goes to what is a solid metal grate in a from roof to ceiling, and she tries to lift it up.
Lift it up, she's like
to open. What on earth are you doing?
Yeah.
This whole part was very, I don't know. I was getting wannabe Cowboy Bebop vibes from this.
Yeah.
The way, like, you know, she comes running in with a sword, like vicious wood, and he's trying to be like Spike Spiegel and shit, and they have like that little fight. And then, yeah, I want to show it where she runs in and cuts her. There she is. She just runs in and just fucking shanks her.
Yeah.
What was that? That's an assassin coming to kill you.
Yep.
And then when the guy comes in and shoots at it, she just jumps through the metal grate, and it just as if it's nothing. It's not. It's not drilled into the wall or anything.
Nope, she just goes right fucking through it. I also love that she does the typical assassin thing where she shows up and immediately tells her, "I'm an assassin. I'm here to kill you." And instead of just running you through and leaving, I'm gonna run the bitch through next to you. Yeah.
Oh my god. And did it even explain how the assassin knew she'd be there?
Nope.
No. Nope. We went straight from the bath scene to that, as far as the woman's concerned.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. We went from
professional. She's a professional. She obviously must be really good at whatever she does, you know?
Then Sorin comes and saves him.
She walked around with a hood down for nearly all of it, so I think there she is. Attracted down.
There she is. Saw her buying a hot dog. Every time I see this dude being close to Halsey, I'm like, oh, no.
Yeah,
don't do it. Don't just think of him. He's like there looking at it right now. Being like,
yeah, I can smell you. Yeah, you smell
the original, the template. Yeah. That's what he calls it.
The template.
I'm pretty sure if I rearrange them in the basement, I can fit another three of them on the radiator.
Yeah, this seems like this seems like a great idea. Do you want to see my basement? I have some really cool stuff down there.
I have a shrine dedicated to you.
He's just got like the Umbrella Corporation under his house, just full of Halseys.
Oh, it's bad. So pretty much he comes in with like, hey, Chief, he might have seen some shit that we really didn't want him to see. And Halsey's like, I kind of predicted this like two episodes would happen, but I kind of forgot. And then, yeah, so John's all pissed off at her. And then here we have it. Halo. Oh,
yeah, and that's them two flirting as well.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, yeah, there was, like, some weird-ass, like, we're sitting way too close, and we keep doing this weird back-and-forth shot. And I'm like...
It pans out, and they're both, like, grinning at each other.
Yep. Well, yeah, and here's the thing. That's the one thing they haven't... box they haven't checked yet. We haven't seen a gay character in the show, and you know that is a priority for these...
You're right.
For these networks.
And what better to have a gay couple than a Spartan who's taken out her stupid silver timeline chip out of her ass?
Yeah, which is very horny.
Miranda Keys, right? Yeah, you have them become the lesbian relationship to get back at what they both would look at as mummy.
Yep. Well, we know that Spartan's horny. At this point, she'll probably have sex with anything.
Yeah. Damn, bitch. You're looking like a double wide surprise.
Yeah. Damn. Them cheeks. Yeah.
We haven't seen hers yet. That's coming.
Yeah. Who had that for bingo?
Oh, we'll bring up the bingo card at the end.
Oh, God, dude.
That is possible. I think it's inevitable that these two get together. It is possible at that point.
Yep. Yeah, I'm calling it. They're gonna have their moment. But yeah, so anyway, do you know what shits me as well? Oh, maybe I haven't
got back in the car, so he put his helmet on.
Yep.
Back in the car, put the helmet on. His bike helmet.
Driving in my mum's car. Yep.
I don't think I can find the exact moment, but this character we're looking at now, she's the first one to say Halo.
Yep.
Because they're trying to translate what the fucking Sangheili is saying, and they're going, sacred ring. And she's like, a halo? Like, that's a pretty big jump.
And please tell me what situation happened where you're shooting an elite in the face and you work out he's saying sacred ring. I'd love to know what kind of logic made you work that one out.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then like Mike said, when she says halo, you hear the, for like half a second.
Like this elite is like hanging out. He's like, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make sure to say everything I can that's going to give away exactly what we're up to. I can't wait.
There is one thing. I think, I'm sure I saw the Halo Music lawsuit has been settled. So you might start seeing Halo Music if they actually can be bothered to put it in the show.
Oh, really? I hope Marty O'Donnell made a fucking fortune out of him. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen. You have Halo Episode 4. Fucking hell.
And it ends on such a like anticlimactic shit note.
It ends with like, oh, Halsey doesn't like glitches in her projects. It's like,
yep. It's like, what the fuck is that supposed to mean?
This whole thing is mummy bad.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck. Yeah. And then they just randomly go into this weird exposition explanation about like Halsey and shit. And we're like, we already knew all this about Halsey. Like, we've been seeing it this whole time. So what's the point of talking about this?
And what they say actually goes against itself in the same thing. It's like, well, she wants to learn what it is to be human. It's like, okay, so how is she doing that? Well, she's cutting out humanity from everything and she sees humanity as a mistake. So, so she's studying humanity by removing humanity, is she? Can you just think about what you're saying for 5 seconds before you put it in a show?
No, Disparu, you know better than that. How dare you?
What gets me about all of this is that went through multiple people, multiple script writers, then it was read through everyone else, and everyone went, yeah, that makes sense.
Yep, 100%.
It's...
the show fucking sucks.
It's really bad. I'm going to give this a 2 out of 10. I'm generous. I'm giving it a 2 out of 10. Episode 3, last week's, I still think is the worst fucking thing I've seen in quite some time.
Yeah, this show is just boring.
I think this is the worst.
You reckon this one was worse than last week?
Because it's so boring. It may not be... The thing is, you care more about the canon and stuff, and that doesn't make so much for me. So I think this was less offensively bad when it comes to the story and stuff, but it was so, so boring.
Yeah, I actually started falling asleep during this episode.
I went to sleep. Yeah, if you watch my video review, I yawn in it as I'm recording.
Episode 4.
Yeah. It's just, I had to go and walk around doing the reviews and stuff, and then it's still the shortest episode, and I barely had anything to talk about in it. Just nothing happens. And there's big, long scenes where they're, like those memory sequences and stuff where nothing happens. And you can just skip all over it because it doesn't take you anywhere.
Yep.
All right, what are you giving it then? I'm giving it a 2. What about you, Disparu?
I think it's 0. I can't stand it. This might be this might be the worst episode of television I've ever seen. Because I've never seen anything this boring. Nothing happened in the entire thing. The only thing I liked was where that one Spartan guy had a fight. And then the car chase. Oh, we missed the car chase where...
That's not even worth showing. It's just...
He avoids the first guy by turning right, and the guy just crashes for no reason. And then you're like, oh, okay, how's he going to get rid of the second? And he just shoots him. The car chase lasts 20 seconds in the most lazy way possible.
Yep. John's right. I'm kind of coming off a good Halo high from earlier this morning, so I'm still in a bit of a good mood, hence the 2. Look at that. Wow. 2 out of 10. You're being too fucking generous, Lethal. Yeah. You fucking shill.
Yeah. You fucking dog. Free
shill, Lethal. You fucking dog.
Like, I actually think that this show is worse than Wheel of Time. That's how bad this is. Like, yeah. Wheel of Time was bad and offensive to, like, the lore and the canon and broke that. But stuff happened. There was at least a show with some kind of plot and some kind of events that happened. This goes nowhere. Nothing happens. There isn't, as far as I'm concerned, this isn't a TV show. It's not entertainment. I don't know what it is.
Something.
What about you, Mike?
Fucking zero. The quality of the show is going downhill. Like I said, you shouldn't, like, the most interesting setting is the woods and leaves, because most of it is either desert or shitty desert set. And this is supposed to be like a futuristic setting. The lab, you barely see any of the fucking lab that they're in. They just, it's shitty set design 101 to just put shit into your set design and go, well, if we make it busy in the background, then nobody can tell that there's nothing actually happening. But that's exactly how this, like, is. The shot quality, the editing is bad. There's a scene, like the fight scene, the first time that Black Spartan 2 guy motherfucker fights somebody, there's like 3 separate different cuts of him grabbing a guy, throwing him on the ground. You're like, why did you need that many cuts to get to this scene? It's just bad. The show fucking sucks.
Fed up of desert planet. It's in everything.
Everything.
Like, they're supposed to have invented like the new technology with the big screen behind them and stuff. I was like, oh, this is going to revolutionize TV making. It's going to be really cheap. And all they show on it is a desert all the time.
Desert planets. Yep. 100%.
You know, we've got to come up with CGI sets and stuff. So instead, we'll just put sand there because it's easy and cheap.
Yep. Well,
because sand is easy and cheap. Yep.
We got 2 more things to go over and then we're going to wrap it up. So episode 5 actually comes out tomorrow. Yeah. Well, technically today for
Maza's
me.
Maza's favorite. He's been looking forward to this for 5.
Yeah, Maza. This is where it all turns around, according to Maza. What if he was 5. Fucking so right?
Imagine if it's the best it's one. Right?
Yeah, what if... Yeah, we watch it and we're like, holy shit, this actually was really fucking good.
The elites come out and they finally arrive and start slaughtering everything.
So we have the preview for episode 5.
Yeah.
I've not seen this. Out.
I haven't seen this either. Yeah.
Oh, you haven't?
No, I haven't. I haven't. Yeah.
Master Chief? About this artifact, analysis suggests the energy it can produce is far greater than that of the magical artifact.
Until I've run some more tests, I'd like you to stay away from it.
I get it now. Things I'm seeing, John. I can't clear you for combat, Kai. You're a danger to yourself and to others.
I'm so dangerous.
He just fucking canceled the bitch.
I don't even understand. Like, he doesn't have it either. Why is he?
Yeah, that's what she said. She's like, what does that make you then? And he's like, bitch, who are you talking to?
A hypocrite.
Yeah.
I'm going to free Metrical even if I'm the only one left to fight.
Your freedom fighter days are over. You belong to me now.
Wait, you can't do this.
You owe me one ship. You're going to work off that debt.
All of that once looks like got Mandalorian. The entire scene could be from The Mandalorian.
Yep.
It kind of did. I haven't even seen the show, but it looks very wannabe fucking Tatooine to me.
If he was in the Mandalorian armor, you wouldn't know.
Yep.
Especially with the way it kind of looks like
one
a kite.
Ship. You're going to work off that debt.
Once they've got the artifact out of the rock, our mission is to get it on board, Pioneer, before the Covenant figures out we're here.
Oh, imagine how many Halsey clones I can make with this.
It's like, what's he doing? Like, waving around. Oh, I'm guiding it in. It's like, what are you doing, dude? I tell you what, though. For casting, if he's meant to be a creepy scientist, they've nailed him. I don't know what it is about him, but he's perfect. Can you imagine if he's not supposed to be creepy?
Oh, Mackie's coming back. Let's go. Yeah. Fingertip lightsabers, side boobs.
Why does she always talk to his gritted teeth? All the time.
And they cannot resist. Oh, we forgot this real quick. This is another thing. I was going to say this. There's a scene when he's walking through his house. He puts his fucking helmet back on, and then they just show his digital face. So even with the fact that he's wearing the fucking helmet, they can't stop showing his goddamn face. It's like, come on. It's not a big deal to just leave his fucking helmet on for 5 seconds. We know he's just looking at shit. He doesn't even have an expression on his face. He's just like,
he never does.
This guy
is in American Gods. He can act. So I don't know why he isn't in this. I can only assume they've told him not to. Yeah, or you better be Spock. Everyone likes Spock.
Yeah. Well, I'm like, Spock's a better actor than this, too. I mean, like, fuck.
10
dude.
Seconds.
He might. Fuck. It's possible.
Muzzle might be right.
If Muzzle's right, I'll go to Australia myself and I'll deal with the problem.
There is a setup in this. If they put action in, it could be the best one.
Obviously we'll go back to streaming at the normal time, right? Because no more Easter. But what if we're like, holy fuck, it was the best one. Muzzle was right.
Well, here's the thing. The only way I'll give it to Muzzle is not because it's the best one of the garbage, is if I actually give the show over a 4. If I can give this episode over a 4, Muzzle was right. I'll give it to him. And I will be as objective as I possibly fucking can about it. If I give it over a 4 rating, Muzzle will be fucking right. And I'll go to Australia and I will deal with Muzzle myself. All right?
To make sure he's never right again.
To make sure he is never right again, I will deal with Muzzle myself.
Imagine like when we go through the stream for like the next episode, we're all backstage. We're like, fuck, it was really good. We have to lie. We have to lie.
Because... Right, guys, I won't be here next week because I have to take down an elder god. So
we can't let this get out that he was right.
Yeah.
Imagine the power he will get.
Yeah.
Coming. Oh no. It might actually be
there
decent.
Will be action. Yeah.
It will be action. But here's the thing.
We haven't had any since the first episode.
This is the thing, and this is a TV show. This is TV show 101. They've been saving the budget for this episode. That's why there's been nothing and why the quality has been so poor, why there's been so many, like, because the thing is, you could almost consider what happened this episode a bottle episode. You could consider episode 2 a bottle episode because the characters stay in very few locations. You don't see a lot going on, and it's mostly dialogue and talking, and they're mostly like stationary because it's a technique to keep the budget low so they can put the bigger budget stuff into a later episode. That's exactly what they fucking did. So, yeah,
shouldn't you put your money at the start and at the end, and then because Stargate always put the filler episodes in the middle of the series.
Yeah, you would think so. That's exactly the right tactic to do. Draw them in with the first good episode, filler in the middle, great finish. No, they don't. I don't think they have any idea for structure of any of this.
Did that really well. I never watched all of it, but Walking Dead, I think, did that. They would just come out the fucking season swinging hard, and then it would be shit, and then there'd be a great ending that you'd want to go.
Great ending, yes. Yeah. But that's the thing. Yeah, you bottle episode in the middle so that you can use the thing. And the thing is, they'll tell you this is the budget for the episodes and how much they actually spend. But we also talked about this too. The budget. And what they say the budget is they gave them that much money to do it, but they can pocket that money. Whatever they don't spend, they pocket. So they might not have spent any of that. They might have spent a quarter of that budget and pocketed the rest. You don't know. We don't know how that money gets distributed because there's also such thing as like sweat equity where they'll say, oh, every episode was $1 million or $10 million an episode. And they'll say, well, charging cost and labor and all that stuff, it costs this much to make, and it really only costs like half of that too. There's a lot of fudging of numbers in stuff like this, but what I'm telling you is this is not a $10 million an episode budget. There's no fucking way. So yeah,
I don't think this show's done anything that like Stargate couldn't have done. Stargate had like towns and cities and stuff, and 100% had the same amount of cast and things.
That's the worst part is a Halo show should be fucking brilliant.
Yeah, and this is the thing. It's not a Halo show on television. It's a Halo show on a streaming service, which means they are not bound by the constraints of a television show. They're not bound by commercial breaks, any of that shit. They have the ability to basically shoot it like a 8-episode movie 8-hour movie. Like, I love that shows. Go fucking Daredevil did it. Like, a lot of these other shows, The Witcher does a lot more episodic, but we're seeing that start to become the new norm now, is they're going back to episodic television, not because they want to, but not because it's warranted, but because they don't know how to write good episodes. At least The Witcher is comprised of a bunch of different shorts and big story arcs throughout multiple stories. It's fucking Halo. They could have wrote this however they wanted to. They decided to make it like a TV show because that's all Paramount fucking knows how to do. You know?
It's very difficult to do a full season on one plot because you've got to come up with a complex idea and carry it through and make it interesting for the entire time.
Yep.
You need far more talent and skill to do that than an episodic one where it's just a one shot.
100%. You know, but we've in the shows that we've seen it done, we know that it's possible. We just, you know, I mean, the thing is, 8 episodes, you could have done it, but they didn't, you know, they didn't try. They didn't get good writers.
I think it's 9.
Yeah, it's a 9 episodes.
So if you've been cutting it down, you think, oh, we're halfway through. No, we're not.
Nope, we're not.
Halfway through the next episode, we'll be halfway. But what if the final episode's like 2 hours or some shit?
Yeah.
No. I don't think I can make it.
No.
Oh, man. I'm still expecting a Luke Skywalker type moment where they're going to bring in someone. I reckon it might be Johnson. At first, I thought it would be Arbiter, but I'm pretty convinced they're still going to do a Arbiter-light story with Marquee, even though that didn't end up being the Mark of Shame and ended up being a taser burn. All right, anyway, place your bets, boys and girls. Disparu, whose butt cheeks are we going to see in Halo Episode 5?
I'm going for the scientist who did the translations.
Oh, Miranda?
Yeah, is she on? Yeah, bottom left.
Yep. Yeah, we're going for Miranda. Anyone else?
I'm going... Go on.
Just her, Disparu?
Yeah.
Cool. All right, lock it in.
Because I think it'll be the couple. I think they'll get together.
Oh, you're right.
So, bottom left and bottom right. That's how I think that's...
Shower scene.
Possibly.
All right, Mike, whose butt cheeks are we going to see?
Halsey's.
Dude, damn! You know what? If Halsey's butt cheeks are in the next episode, it's automatically the best episode so far.
Like I said, I got to give it over a 4, and I'm going to be honest, and I will be objective, and I'll even give it slightly the benefit of the doubt. It's got to be over a 4 for Maza to be right.
Now,
okay?
I'm going to say... Now, this isn't what I want. This is what I think's going to happen. I think we're going to get some man butt. I'm going with Ray Swap Jacob Keys in episode 4, Butt Cheeks.
Well,
I'd love to know what excuse they're going to come out if that's true, though.
They're going like to come out
for no reason.
And they're going to come up and talk to him. They're going to come out going, Keys, we got to talk to you. And he's going to walk out of the shower and go, what's going on?
Naked as fuck.
Just swinging in the breeze.
Yep.
Yeah, so we'll see his butt cheeks are next, man.
I do want to see the Covenant Elites, though.
Yeah. What?
He seems to be saying Halo. No, he's talking about his ring.
Oh, dearie me. Yeah, we'll see. We shall see. But I think we're going to wrap it up here, boys and girls. Thank you so much for coming out. Again, we did this a few days late because of Easter. But we should be getting back into the swing of things properly over the weekend if timing works out for everyone. Big shout out to Lady Gravemaster for beating the shit out of some guy, then coming on a stream. Like, yeah, what of it? Nothing fucking happened. Like, no big deal. Disparu, what have you got coming up in the next few days, you fucking dragon?
Hold on.
We got a hot take here. No cheeks.
I don't know about that. I mean, a battle from start to finish, someone is going to get like a bomb dropped on them and it's going to burn their trousers off or something. So they're going to find a way.
Oh, shit. But yeah, sorry, Disparu. I saw that. I was like, God damn, that's a hot tag.
Just released a Pedro Pascal video, which is similar to Halo, actually. I bring up Halo in it. When the fact that, the Last of Us, I didn't actually want to play any of it because it might ruin my interpretation of Joel. It's like, yeah, that's because you can only play Pedro Pascal. You can't play Joel. So you're just coming up with the excuses now. But then I'll get the Halo review out either tomorrow or the day after, Friday. And yeah, follow me on YouTube and Twitch, Disparu.
Fuck yeah. And thank you for coming on, Disparu. I really appreciate it.
Ah, no,
you hit 17K yet or what?
I'm 8 off.
8 off. There we go. We'll be there in the morning, mate. And what about you, Mike?
Yeah. You can go check me out, twitch.tv/the_epic_Mike. Closing in on 600 followers. Views have been great. Views have been doing really, really good. I'm having a blast streaming with people. Got more Elden Ring. Been working behind the scenes on some, got some cool boss fights coming up and stuff like that that I've been working on, you know, setting some shit up. So like next time I stream, which actually might be tonight, I have some action-packed stuff for you. You can check me out tonight on Splatoon on Gaming with Geeks. You can check me out tomorrow in the morning, possibly with Lethal, Disparu, and Blabs. And then you check me out in the evening on the D&D stream, Geeks and Gamers Tabletop. I'm everywhere. And then Saturday, you can check me out on Josiah Rises live stream, because we're actually doing a live stream on Saturday. So we're just back to it again. So, yeah.
Fuck yeah. Appreciate you coming out here. And again, shout out to Lady G for coming on as well. And yeah, I'll have the next Halo episode up tomorrow after I've seen it. And yeah. We'll go from there. So big shout out to Disparu, Mike, Lady G, and of course the chat for coming out. Thank you to all the channel members, you absolute legends. And yes, I will see you all later. Ta-ta.
Oh, sorry. You probably thought I was a drop bear. Now it's me, Bush Barbie. And today, I'm here to talk to you about dingers. Because like you, this bush has seen a cockatoo. Regardless if you like it deep in the bush or prefer it in the outback, make sure you look after your wombat hole. So many critters can get down there. And believe me, it's enough to make your dango go drier than a dead dingo's donger in the desert. So don't do it. Even if he is a fun guy. Yeah, so by all means go wild. Just make sure you take a moment, in the moment, to use a moment, so you can keep the devil out of your tassie and the jelly out of your box. That's it.